Sup with it? Welcome to Melee and Army, episode 6. Music plays in the background. Welcome, my name is Scar. I am one of your hosts. Joining me is Sheridan, aka Huga, Prague, and Cactuar. And Prague, dude, I was trying to think of a sweet Job line that whole time and came up with absolutely nothing.
Can I think of anything?
I'm like, no, the come whole on. Time. The whole time. Yeah, if I had said come on, that would have been 800 times better with what I came up with, which is nothing.
Dude, I missed my part during the intro because I was refreshing my stream. What would you have up for me?
Dude, you had like 800 million rests. It was the best thing ever.
Did you have me neutral air resting over Triforce?
I had you versus Lovage 3 rests.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I also missed my part, but I'm not going to ask about it right now.
But what is up? This is Melee It On Me, episode 6, the final countdown, 6 hours to midnight. You guys know what we're here for. We know what we're here for. We're trying to get our game into EVO 2013. And so far, we have killed it and raised an astonishing $43,500. That is the count. We are starting at 43.5K. And we are going to be working up from there to understand how much you guys are going to make us match. As you probably know, we have $4,500 in the pot. I'm starting the tally now so that I don't lose it at any point. And so every dollar you donate from this point forward will be doubled up until 4.5K. Donate now. Mods, please help me out by linking the donation link. So, with that said, we're going to get right into the agenda. Sheridan or Prague, you guys want to take it away while I work on this spreadsheet real quick?
Well, you want to just have us introduce ourselves? You want to start, Bobby? Tell us a little bit about yourself?
I guess I could start. Do you guys want me to start?
Man, you got the momentum, man. Let's hear it.
I feel honored. So, welcome to this show. It's called Melee and On Me, and I'm your host, Scar. I'd like to tell you just a little bit about myself and what circumstances in life led me to this very moment here on stream before you. So, maybe, what was it, 2007? Cactuar probably knows this story about as well as I do. I had a good friend who I played Super Smash Bros. 64 with, and it was pretty fun. I played Captain Falcon because he's pretty cool and fast and strong, and I liked him a lot. And, when Melee came out, it was like a dream come true. Had more characters, had crazy stages. What's going on? So we played this game, all the time for years. And one day I stumbled into the wrong room where there were a bunch of people playing this game that I thought I was probably one of the best at. One of them was Cactus Smash, Cactuar, also Pac-Man, and several other Drexel kids who were significantly better than any of us. I think every Smasher has had this experience where they're like, hey, man, I'm so good at this game. And then you play like a competitive player, and it's like, oh, did I hit that guy? I was playing Ganondorf at the time, who's super good. And, man, I've been in the competitive community since, like, 2007. I was overhyped by my combo video, I Killed Mufasa. It's a trilogy. You should probably watch all three right now if you haven't. And, since then, I've just been going to every tournament that I can, taking a few breaks here and there, but right now, there is so much momentum and fire in this community that here I am, and I'm not going anywhere. And we just started this show, month and a half ago? I think that's way off.
2 months ago, yeah.
Okay, 2 months ago. And it's been great. We love talking, love hanging out. From deep down inside, I'd like to say that, since 2007, my friends and my family have become the very people in this Twitch chat, the very people watching this stream, the very people on this call with me, and who will be calling in from now on. So that's Scar. It's wrapped up. It's a wrap. We're going down now. That was episode 6. I'm just kidding.
That was beautiful, Scar.
Thanks, dude. Who's next?
All right, Prague.
Sheridan, up to you.
Okay, well, I'll go next. So, my name is Sheridan, a.k.a. Huga, and I joined the scene actually way back in 2004.
Oh, my God.
My first tournament was TG6. Bob Money was there, and Violence was there, too. I just learned this. So, a lot of great people came out of that. And that was actually Matt Deasy's last tournament that he ran, and he was kind of the big NorCal tournament organizer at that point, up until that point. And so kind of later on in my Smash career, starting probably around 2007, I started becoming the main NorCal tournament organizer. And me and Boback and the rest of DBR, we all got together and put on the Genesis tournaments, 2009, 2011. And so, you know, I've been really big in running running the NorCal tournament scene for quite a long time. I've got a whole bunch of experience running all that stuff. And also right now, I'm only a few weeks away from defending my PhD in physics.
Get him, Sheridan.
So that's going to be very exciting. And I also just learned that I got called in to audition for Jeopardy next month. Because I apparently did pretty well on the online test, so I'm pretty darn excited to hopefully make one of my live streams come true and get on Jeopardy.
What is the chemical symbol for boron?
B.
So, ask him a Jeopardy question. We gotta test him. What else? Where is Mount Vesuvius?
Italy. Dude, no. Here's what's gonna kill me.
No, you have to say what is Italy. Boom! You lose.
No, because you didn't state it in the form of an answer. You didn't state it in the form of an answer. So, anyway, so that's me. So, let's hear about Prague with those double shades on, looking hella good.
Actually, they are triple shades. But I started back, I guess, 05, 06, and kind of like what Scar said, I was one of the up-and-coming smashers at Temple University. And I happened to one day walk to, after I found Smash Boards, there's this guy named Cactuar who, he was like, yeah, why don't you guys come over and play? And, you know, Cactuar, Pac-Man, Chibo Senpai, Dot Eater, Will, Chocobo, that one kid I don't remember. I can see his face, but I don't remember the name. But they kind of bodied us all, and from there was just a love affair. Eventually, after Scar moved to the West Coast and Pac-Man stopped recording, I started uploading stuff to YouTube. Eventually, stopped playing, started commentating more and more often, and that's why I'm here today. And hopefully, I find out what you guys want from Melee on this evening. I'm doing pretty good tonight. I had a little medical procedure earlier today. I'm not feeling the best, but I'm going to fucking hide it because I'm good like that. And I think we're going to finish up with, I mean, my story had to do with Cactuar, Scar, so do yours. It's kind of fitting to end with this guy over here.
The architect of PA Smash.
Is that me?
It is.
All right.
What's up, Cactus? How you doing, man?
Pretty good. I just got over being sick from Apex, thankfully. Still feeling a little bit, you know, clogged up, but
the A-plague picks.
Feel way better now. Anyway, so my story kind of starts late 2005. I mean, I was just an incoming freshman at Drexel, and I used to play on the first floor of that dorm with a bunch of other guys from Drexel, also freshmen, and we had no idea what was going on, no idea about the competitive scene. And I found out we had a game room down in Drexel's main building, and I went down there, and I think I was still a Roy main at the time. I played against Pac-Man's Luigi, and he just four-stocked me. Most embarrassing. And I was determined from that point to not get four-stocked by this guy, come back there and beat everybody. So, I mean, I practiced that, but luckily during the summers, I spent time up in Jersey, so I met up with Waz and the TSA crew, and I mean, they really exposed me to the tournament scene more and let me kind of see what they were doing and kind of take what they already had for their local region and expand on it. So after that, I came back to Drexel, and I was the best after the summer. And anyway, that's the story of me being better than I was. And then, let's see.
A truly compelling tale of personal growth.
After that, anyway, got to travel up to New York a lot and play with the DA and most of the southern New York crew, more towards New York City. I met Prague at some point coming to Temple around that time. Met Scar around that time as well. And, I mean, it's kind of just been propelling forward since then. So even though I take breaks too, I always try to keep in touch with the scene and see what everybody's doing and see what they want. And, I mean, that kind of led to me being put associated with the MBR. And now we just work on what you guys want. So that's kind of what the point of this is. What do you guys want?
Indeed. Indeed, that is the point. Prog, am I just reading this?
I mean,
no, so yeah. let's you know, we're all here for this.
So
for
now
this
you guys
donation.
Know us.
Yeah. So we're all here to do this big donation drive to get us into Evo. So why don't we explain the background for all that? Let's talk about what Evo is, why we want to be in Evo, and what this drive's all about.
Wow, those are some really big topics.
Evo essentially is the Olympics of fighting games. If the Olympics were every year instead of every 4 years, not including the Winter Olympics, because unless you watch Cool Runnings religiously, no one cares about the Winter Olympics.
I like ice hockey. Get out of here with that.
Well, you're like half Canadian, so.
Dude, Cool Runnings is like one of the top five best movies in the world, right? Anybody? Feel
yeah.
Rhythm, feel the rhyme? Sheridan, I don't even want to hear from you, dude.
Nah, it's pretty good.
All right.
But essentially, it is such a huge, huge event. And there are 8 games that were being chosen this year. The first 7 have already been selected. And in a venerable offer, there was a Facebook vote. And any game that got over 500 votes was considered for getting that 8th spot. However, of course, there's a hitch, but it's a good one. We're raising money to fight breast cancer, and it's a really, really awesome thing. You know, Mr. Wizard, one of the guys who is behind all of this, he knows how competitive each of these games that are being selected can be, not only in the game, but against other people, other communities, and he's put us all up against one another, one by one. So already the 3 big communities, ourselves, Skullgirls, and Super Street Fighter 2 Turbo, has already raised 6 figures. We're already over, probably I'm guessing, 110,000 at this point, just because it's been insane. So a big shout out to all those guys. So all these games are in the running. It's not just those 3. There are plenty more that are raising funds, and you know it's definitely a great cause. So shouts to those other communities, definitely. So, and that being said, Scar, we've already opened up the floodgates, right?
We have opened up the floodgates. So any donation that you guys make now, go, 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 go. Mods, please feel free to link to the donation link every 5 minutes or so. And there's also a WePay link in the VG Bootcamp information thing, and that's going to go to me, and I will donate every single dollar, of course. I hope you guys trust me at this point, and I'll, of course, stream the receipt, so on and so forth. So, yeah, the floodgates are indeed open. I'm not sure if I want to check, but...
I kind of want to, you know, since all these people are donating, I just want to say, you know, I like being generous sometimes, so... I actually met G-Money and D1 a few weeks ago, both New York Smashers, who, if you guys aren't aware. I happened to just be in line at Nintendo World, and they were having this Legend of Zelda event. So I figured, why not stop by? And I happened to pick up this. Can you guys see this? This is a Legend of Zelda Link coloring page. Like, that's so dope. And also, like, they gave me this Master Sword.
Oh my
it's
god.
Amazing. But also, they gave me this book. It's not really that good. Wait, it's shrink-wrapped. It has golden pages. It's leather-bound. This is the limited edition Legend of Zelda Hyrule Historia. I think there are only 4,000 copies of it made. And I happen to just be giving it away. So any of you that want to go ahead and email me, it's progducto@gmail.com with proof of donation of $20 or more, go ahead and email me, and someone by the end of this evening will be receiving it. So, yeah.
Incredible.
Are you going to just pick one of them at random?
I'm going to pick someone completely random. I have an Excel spreadsheet, and actually, what else do I have?
And I would suggest that
what do you
everybody
know?
Else...
I have another page.
Whoa!
Everybody else that's raffling off items, make sure you organize it and get people to email you their proof of donation and, you know, set it up however you want, but make sure you figure out how to organize your raffles. So tonight is, in case you haven't noticed, tonight is the very last night, so donations are going to end. This contest is going to be over at 11:59:59 Pacific Time, which is a little bit over 5.5 hours from now.
That is right. Is that all you had to say on the topic?
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, that's
it's ending. It's ending, guys. This is the last push. This is our last stand. Like, I feel like we got to play some 300 music, you know.
Spartans?
At the very worst, yes. Spartans! At the very worst, we are going to die a glorious death, right? That is at the bare minimum.
Absolutely.
And at best, we will find ourselves tonight as the eighth game on the main stage at EVO 2013. Both are exciting. One's more exciting. You just can't worry about that. I mean, you know.
That's right.
One's better. So that's that.
But, you know, we couldn't have done this without a lot of people. So I think we should definitely, like, shout out everyone that's really been there for us.
I just want to say I'm really impressed just, like, how much initiative so many people have taken in this. I mean, it's really easy in something like this where, you know, you might feel like your individual donation gets kind of lost in it all, but just so many people have stepped up and, you know, really taken it into their own hands that they want to get... You know, they want to get this game into EVO. So many people have been, making, put their own stuff up for auction, or reached out to other former community members, other streamers, their families. And I mean, when I look at that that board, that subboard on Smashboards, I mean, that's just people are posting all the time about stuff that they're doing, and I'm extremely impressed by that because I always think of Smashers as just kind of lazy people who just, you know, let everything happen. You know, they're content to let everybody else do something for them. But this is kind of put a little bit more faith in the Smash community for me, and I think for most of us. So I'm super impressed by that.
I definitely have to agree.
Beautiful sentiment, but can I just backtrack and ask you to clarify? So if I put you in a vacuum, no air, no anything...
Bobby, I think you cut out.
Just cut out.
I was just so shocked.
So you put me in a vacuum, and then what happens?
And I asked you to think of a Smasher. Just take a, just put it in your brain. What what pops into your head again?
Mewtwo King.
That's fair.
An amazing example of, you know, someone who is, at least for me, and I know everybody I've talked to, everybody is just like, you know, that's Mewtwo King? That's Mewtwo King going out, hustling his heart out? He's messaged like 700 billion people today. I think that everybody in the earth has heard from Mewtwo King today. Hey, totally. Join this group. Donate here. Blah, 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 blah. Amazing, amazing hustle. This is like the most amazing thing I've ever seen. Just shattered all expectations. But point being... All right, anyway, whatever.
Point being...
It was a beautiful sentiment. Yeah, I think that we definitely, as a community, have sort of put our flag down and said, this is what we're about. This is what we're capable of. And we're legit.
Totally.
But we definitely reached out from beyond the community as well, so
absolutely.
I think we should shout some of those individuals out.
Absolutely, dude.
So, I mean, I'm not sure how many of you guys have been watching all the various people that have been doing tons of stuff for us this week. So, first off and foremost, we got to start with the Smash community on the whole. You know, this isn't just Melee that's working for us. 64 have been doing their stuff for us. They've been streaming for us. Brawl has been streaming, donating, Project Melee. The entire Smash community, whether it's Smash Boards, Always Brawl, Smash For You, Reddit, Game Facts, all these different communities have been coming together under one flag to help fight breast cancer and to get Smash game back at EVO. So definitely a huge shout to them. And also, you know, it's kind of weird how a lot of these Smashers end up, after they retire, they move to the speedrunning community. So, I mean, we've had a myriad of streamers this week, including guys like Trihex, who's been doing three stuff. Like, I think he's done a stream Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday night of Yoshi's Island, making Hobby look not technical at all. Oddler, who had, I think, was it 48 hours or 72 hours? I think it was 48 hours of him playing Legend of Zelda games, which was nuts. Like, I took two naps while he was doing that. I'm sorry, Oddler. I got more sleep combined in my nap than you got over 2 days. I'm sorry. Of course, MoFat, who's been doing Twilight Princess runs. I saw him this morning. He's been doing great. Khalid Hart, 42, has been streaming. Smith, as well, from North Carolina. He was one of the guys that helped reach out, as well as Strong Bad, as well. And, of course, you know, people from our own crew, former Smashers, Cosmo, Siglemic, Peaches, a.k.a. 18 Spikes, who have all shown their support. So definitely follow those guys and follow them on Twitter, on twitch.tv, and give them a shout-out. And again, like you said, you know, Mita King did so much organizing with that. It's insane.
It's insane.
But also, I mean, he also said, you know, he reached out to the League of Legends community, shout out to Mogwai out there, but to Dyrus, who said, you know, if I was able to support you guys, I would. I'm a fan of the community. Keep it up. So all you League players, definitely shout him out. And one more person I want to acknowledge before, you know, Scar, you can continue down the list. There's this one guy out there in Brazil who donated $4,000, but he didn't.
Oh!
What? But it didn't matter, because he inspired everyone in that moment. So, Salsa, big thanks to you. You definitely got everyone so hyped. You know, you are the man. All right, Scar, you can keep going.
I thought you were going to shout out me. Actually. It's like, and then there's this one guy. And I was like, oh my God. I started to blush. I was like, bro, I was going to say Scar. He's been working so hard. It's not true.
Well, I mean, I think everyone who is in this stream already knows how hard he's been working.
Oh, yeah.
We all have,
you know. I mean, I think that the very beginning, right, is that it's a community effort. We are, you know, it's like a one unit kind of thing. We have each other's back. You know, it's just sick, sick, nasty, and we couldn't do it without each other. So yeah, you called out a ton of people. You know, the biggest shouts that I have are to I would like to thank Trihex one more time, because, like, you know, wow, dude, he's actually like probably the coolest guy in the world. You know,
cooler than me.
You know, maybe 50-50. I'd love to see you both on Jeopardy and, like, you know, settle it once and for all. He's super cool, man. I think that he supported us so hard. Like, one night he raised over 2K. You know, his fan base is gigantic. He redirected a ton of traffic to my site, which is just awesome. So if you want to support him, somebody just linked his Twitter. Just click on it, follow him. Head on over to his Twitch channel. It's twitch.tv/trihex, T-R-I-H-E-X. And press the follow button. He is so, so awesome. And then everybody who agreed to do a match with me, you know, it was shout outs to Prague for having that amazing idea, which I think started it all. You know, we were kind of in this race where it was like $3,000, oh, it's so much money, what are we going to, you know, how are we going to really push this number up? Here we are, you know, 3 weeks later with 10 times that amount. And it all started with the idea to match and our work as a community to organize and just, you know, come together and sort of recognize that when we work together, we make something bigger than the sum of our parts. So
and yet all one unbreakable unit.
It's just a beautiful thing, man. So shouts really quickly to our matchers tonight. So like I said, we have 4,500 in matching. We actually jacked some of the Trihex money and put it into the pot. Thanks to Trihex for that. It's 1,200 from Trihex and his fans. I'm giving him a round of applause. $500 each from Violence, Atlas 8, Yarok, Tafikins, and Toph. $200 from Akrite. $100 from Zoso, Zope, Greenblatt Sam, Hectohertz, Hugs.
Here you go.
And Europhoria. Thank you guys so much. And $50 from Juggle Guy. That is what we are. That's the charging that we're doing right now. We're charging up to $4,500 so that we can release the Super Spirit Bomb Melee onto the world. If we hit our goal, all of our donors are going to throw in all of this money. It'll be at about 9 o'clock p.m., so in about 2.5 hours from now, and we will just shatter everything that's ever existed. So yeah, shout-outs to all of you guys, and shout-outs to everybody who's watching the stream right now. Give yourselves a... See what I just did? Do that. Do that to your back. So those are my thanks, man.
Yeah. And, I mean, just all the people who have given incentives and just everybody who's been donating, it's completely just mind-blowing to me. I did not expect any of this. But also, you know, let's thank the other communities that are doing this as well. You know, without the competition from the Skullgirls community, yeah, without the competition from the ST community, I don't know if, you know, the Smash community would have banded together, you know, this tightly and this quickly to get all this stuff done. I mean, their motivation has been our motivation. And, you know, we've been reacting to everything that they've been doing, and we've just been pushing each other harder and harder the whole time. Yeah. So I think, you know, Mr. Wizard had a great idea with this because he knows that we're all very competitive people and that, you know, this kind of phenomenon would probably happen. So big shout-outs to Skullgirls, to Super Turbo, to all the other communities, and to Mr. Wizard for putting this on together, for giving us the opportunity to really show everybody, you know, not just that we can put in a bunch of money, but that, you know, our communities are really strong and, you know, we're really cohesive and we have that fire to get into Evo. So definitely huge thanks to those guys.
Absolutely. And let me give one more to my man Bionic, who is the guy who is always working behind the scenes on Smashboards. You've probably noticed a bunch of notifications at the very top popping up, redirecting you to the stream, you know, directing you to the donation link. This is all of his hard work. You know, he's amazing, and, you know, he really powers the hub. Yeah, in Bionic we trust. Thank you so much, Bionic. I just wanted to shout you out, dude. So, yeah. Hey, man. What else? Are we going to talk about Nintendo? Are we going to thank Nintendo? You want to just go down the list? I thank Nintendo. Yep. Hey, man, we spent so much. How many hours do you think? I'd love to go around and ask, how many hours do you think you actually spent playing this game?
Oh, my
God. It just, like, explodes God. My brain to think about.
I don't know if I want to know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
One of those things is better left unsaid.
Yeah. Do you know if, like, you can go into the GameCube and find out, like, what the power time is? Like, how long it's been powered? Because
90% of that
I know, yeah, I know 90% of that is Melee for me. And I got a GameCube the very day it came out. So,
oh my God.
I mean,
somebody figure out how to do that, and we're going to run an experiment, and we're going to...
Yeah.
We're going to do it, man.
And my memory card has lost its data 3 times, and I mean, every time that I lost it, I was already at, like, you know, if you've played a whole bunch of Melee matches, you know, you get like those kind of little mini achievements that pop up. You know, you play 4,995 matches, it tells you, you know, you've played this money. That's about 1 cent per match.
Yeah.
And I've and there's a 10,000 one, and I'm pretty sure I've seen that at least 3 times.
There's
so,
a 10,000 one?
There's a, I think there's even a 100,000 one.
Man, those guys.
Yeah.
Cocky. To expect that somebody would see that.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah, what an amazing game. We love it, love it, love it. And another shout to VG Bootcamp. Hey, man. Gimmer, thanks so much for having us on the stream. You're pulling in tons of people, and I want to reach everybody who's watching. This heart is for everybody. It's for Gimmer, but it's for everybody. Yeah. We got a few more, but we can come back to him, too.
Yeah. Well, not to toot my own horn a little bit, but let's give a big shout-out to all the tournament organizers and all the staff who've been running, you know, Melee tournaments and bringing us together for so long. I mean, what would this be without Genesis, without Apex, without FC, you know? So let's thank the efforts of those people who've gone out of their way, you know, who've made it, you know, a big part of their life to get everybody together and deal with all those things that nobody else wants to deal with to, you know, make those big tournaments happen.
And, you know, kind of, I don't want to toot Scar's horn, but, you know, where would we be without, I don't know, Revival and Melee?
Rom, dude.
Where would we be without I Killed Mufasa?
These are questions that, you know, they're just, when you think about it, it's scary to even think about a world without that video.
Do you really know what I mean?
It's like, Imagine you never saw I Killed Mufasa. It's just like, what? The landscape of my life, my love life, my relationship with my parents, you know, all of this stuff is just suddenly in a state of confusion.
Who will champion the people without without that?
Mango. I think Mango will pick up the crown.
Anyway. And, of course, you know, all the streamers and all the commentators who've really kind of put Melee, you know, brought it to a more professional level. I mean, you thought it was big. I mean, we thought the community was doing really well in 2006 when we were at MLG. But, I mean, with all the commentators, and now, like, every tournament's got streams and commentators, and the videos are up, you know, they're up after every tournament within a couple days. So, I mean, big shout-outs to all those people who are really kind of broadening the base of our community and just really making it look so professional compared to what it used to be. I mean, it's really advanced the image of the game.
It can go either way.
You can go either way?
You can go either way, man.
I don't know.
Yeah. If only the chat was all in this call, we would just hear laughter. Dude, Cactus, are you there? I haven't seen your thing move.
I am here.
Are you on
mute? He was making waffles for a while.
Ah, how are they?
They're imaginary. I really wish I had made waffles.
Are they homemade waffles? Yes!
Actually,
we did it!
You know, I hate to do this, but I'm going through the emails that everyone's sending me, and actually, we got a letter.
From who?
So, here is my donation. I do wonder, though, if I would have made it tonight. I donated this, skipping a lot of this part, but I am proud to help out the community. That has helped bring me so much happiness throughout the years. I may not have been to a tournament in years, but I want to dust off my old GameCube controller and join the hype. If Melee gets in, I will be on a flight to Evo 2013 to enter my first 23 years, and I am so happy to have that opportunity to help, even if it isn't much in the grand scope of things. Thank you guys so much for bringing the community back on full swing. I love all of you guys, and I'm happy to contribute in any amount. So shouts to Rick Shaw out there in NorCal. One unit.
NorCal. Thank you. That was very touching. I hope to see you in NorCal. We're going to have that tournament. We're going to have tournaments. We got one this week. We got one in 2 weeks.
Dude, tournaments on tournaments.
Yeah, baby.
So we're talking about World Warriors. Prague, why don't you walk us through the path. Okay.
Sure. Like everyone knows, you know, we are fighting breast cancer, and if we are fortunate enough, we will also end up on that main stage at Evolution 2013. And, you know, we can't do this without all of you guys, your donations, your efforts, because one unit, like we've been preaching all night long, you know, it's not just one person. It's everyone from that one person picking up their their controller for the very first time, all the way to Armada. It's a group collective, and we can't do it without everyone. So thank all of you for your efforts, for your donations. You guys are why we have this lifeblood. You guys are the heart behind Melee. You guys are just giving us the blood to keep it running. So, that being said, we have this amazing global community. You know, it's not just the United States. It's been far beyond that. And we've definitely learned that a lot more in the recent years. I mean, what do you expect from a game that's 12 years old? And it seems like more and more every year we do get more and more people from around the world being represented on our big stages. So definitely shouts to all these countries that are being represented. You know, Canada kind of did first blood, I'd say, with guys Kirby Kaze, Unknown, Kage, and over in the West Coast, that whole crew of, like, Diakonos, Bonded Object, Die Slow. I'm missing players in there, Tekt. But Canada has been doing it for years, for everyone. Idea. There's a Weon X. Well, he's technically from Chile, but they have done so
no,
much.
No, he's not.
He's from Chile.
Weon X?
Yes, sir.
Wow. Dude, Weon, so good, man. I didn't know you were from Chile. How you doing?
And then, of course, you know, in recent years, we know how Europe has been traveling in mass. You guys just saw the podcast before us with Armada, King Funk, Levin, Fuzziness, Shloka. There's plenty, tons more out there. Ice, Amsa. I could go on for days. But we don't have that much time. We saw this year for a huge representation in all the Smash games from Japan. So definitely shout out to all those guys.
Gucci!
Yes, sir, especially Gucci, and of course, the red, the white, and the green. Anyone that's seen Blue Streak, I hope you get that reference.
No, seriously, you said it, and I was like, well, I've heard that before. Where the heck is that Martin Lawrence?
Of course, you know, the Mexican scene, you know, Javi, Azza, JPG, Tuga, tons of players out there, and that's just those who have had the opportunity to make it up here. Especially, you know, everyone that's seen the Arita Knobs video, you know that Chile, besides Weon X, is ready to be represented. So be on the lookout for those guys. But we all know about all these different zones in the United States as well, and all these scenes are thriving. East Coast, West Coast, Midwest, the South, everywhere is thriving. I remember at Pound 5, we had, like, I think 6 or 7 Smashers from Alaska. Like, Alaska? Really? So it just goes to show, like, how deep we are, like, how global we are as a community. And I know Scar definitely wants to hit on that.
I do. I wanted to hit on something really quickly, though. I wanted to talk about what time it is, which is 6:45, which is my time. Your time is 9:45, so you probably can't call your mom right now, right? But I do want to say that... This is, again, this is like the last stand. This is the spirit bomb. We are all collectively putting our hands up and saying, you know, we need to, like, end the world right now. So if you can't, like, donate, if there's something in your way, but you have the money or you'll have the money in a little bit, I think that it's a sick idea to, like, ask one of your bros to, you know, to donate for you and you'll pay them back in the next tournament. Or if you can ask your friends, hey, you know, every $5 goes so far, you know, so you could say, hey, buddy, you know, I know Timmy that you love Smash, and you know that I love it so much, so if you want to donate $20, I'll put it in the pot for you, and you just give it to me tomorrow. You give it to me at lunch. Call your mom, call your dad, go upstairs, talk to your sister. Hey, sis, you have like $5 that I could borrow? Take it, put it in your pocket, and then donate $5. This is the time. Let's do it. That's all I really wanted to say. But shout-outs to U.S. players. You guys are awesome.
And then, you know, it's not... A lot of people jokingly say, you know, it always boils down to Fox, Falco, Final Destination. Look at our majors. When was the last time that happened in Grand Finals? I mean, earlier in the podcast, right before, this last match we saw was Hacks, of course, playing Captain Falcon against Mofo playing Ness. There are plenty of low-tier mains out there who do big things. So it's
We had Ness versus Young Link in one of the top matches in the bracket at Apex.
How'd that happen?
Yeah. And I know a lot of people who are listening are working on trying to develop their scene. Some are just trying to find them. So, of course, we want to recognize that there are a lot of ways for you to go ahead and check things out. So starting off, of course, with the original mecca of Smashboards.com. If you want advice on matchups, on characters, regional people that you're looking to play, tournaments that are going on, streams when they're happening, they have it all on there. Smash for You is kind of like our event hubs as it's being developed. A lot of news, a lot of the same stuff, really nice layout. It's up and coming, but definitely it's something that you guys need to subscribe to as well. All these different communities that everyone's come from. I mean, Scar, when you first got into Smash, you got into it from a friend.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Like, when you found out about competitive play, where was the first place you went?
Drexel Lounge.
I mean, like, internet-wise.
Smashboards.
Okay.
Was that the question?
How about you,
did I answer it?
Yeah, that's the right answer. That's the right answer.
I was actually on Smashboards like a year before I went to my first tournament. I got a 2003 join date, so beat that.
What the? Smashboards was around then? Holy shite.
I think he's still making waffles.
Smashboards?
Yeah. Smashboards? Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I was actually first on GameFAQ's message boards. Yeah, that's how I first found out about everything, and then eventually found out about Smashboards down the line. And we have sites like All's Brawl, Smash for You. There's a lot of different options out there.
But did you guys all just like search for that online for Smashboards? Because, I mean, I know I said Smashboards, but the way I got to Smashboards was through Pac-Man. It wasn't anything before that. I was referred there by somebody else.
Yeah, I think I learned about it from Game FAQs, I believe.
Yeah,
I learned about it from Game of Thrones as well.
Hey, can I build on that?
By all means.
Speaking of people helping you get better, you know, Smashboards was like, oh, by the way, I don't know if anybody knows about this, but at 8:30, which is in maybe like an hour and a half, we're actually going to have the King of Smash, Sephiroth Ken, come on the call. Does everybody know about this?
I was not aware.
Let's talk about our guest for tonight.
Well, I'm going to mention Ken because the first time I ever asked for help on the boards, one of them was Review Scar's Marth, looking for some tippers, which I think that like everybody has probably, I think that joke was made a million times, and Ken posted something that made no sense to me at the time. He was like, you know, okay, so you're like probably not the worst in the world, but you're like, here's the worst, here's you, here's pretty good, here's Gosu, and here's Ken. And I was like, whoa, Ken responded to my Ken responded to my thread. Point being, this is an opportunity to get more than Ken gave me. Okay, so I'm about to link something in the chat. This is a sweet form, a Google form. I don't know if you've ever used one, but basically, if you donate tonight, or if you have in like the past, I don't know, couple weeks, but anyway, if you donate, especially tonight, you can get training from basically literally anybody you want. Anybody who's willing to come on any podcast, they will watch any set that you pick. It could be of yours, it could be of your friends, and you could also record a set later and then submit it to me. So go to that link if you want literally anybody to train you. $50, you can get like 15-minute or half an hour or whatever session with Mango. You can get a session with Armada. You can get a session with PP, M2K. Boom! What do you want?
Wait, did you say PP and M2K?
Yeah, dude.
Wait, what?
I'm not even kidding. You should do it, Prog. You should just... I'm putting my money in. I'm not even kidding. I'm getting Johnny to watch some of my stuff and Mango to watch some of my stuff. If you want Mutant King to literally watch one of your games and talk about it live on stream, you can. I'm going to ask Ken if he'll do it. He might do it. That would just be the most helpful thing ever. So yeah, anyway, and yeah, let me talk about my guest really quickly. So Alpha Zealot is scheduled to come on at 7:00, and he gave me he wants to give us a sneak preview of the new Smashboards layout. This is a big deal for us because it's pretty much been the same for a long time. You know, not there have been incremental improvements, but this is like an overhaul. So that's pretty sick, man. We get a sneak peek right here on the show. AZ, I don't know if you shared it with anybody. I don't know if you still want to share it with people, but whatever. Let me know. We're planning on bringing you on in like 10 minutes. And then 20 minutes after that, we were going to have the main homie Bionic on to talk to us a little bit more about Smash Boards, tell us a bit about Zen 4-0. And I think that the sort of the driving point of these two conversations are going to be like, you know, here's Melee. Here's what we've been able to do. Like, check out what we've done in the past four weeks. It's like pretty amazing. So we really need something to keep us together and help us build on this. Definitely don't want to lose this this super tight connection and sense of unity that we have. Building off of unity, my boy Reno, R3N0, you should probably type in the 3 every time you talk about him, is going to come on and tell us a little bit about a fun idea that he had with regards to teams. We talked about teams extensively last time. I think it may have been on the after show, but maybe it was on the real show. And we talked a little bit about how the two best players in the venue team together. That sucks, man. We're going to lose because they're so good. So we're going to talk a little bit about something fun that we can do to, you know, to make teams exciting, to keep teams exciting. And then we're going to take a little break and talk about, you know, talk about other stuff. Just chill, have a good time, probably follow the agenda. And at 8:30, the former King of Smash and the Evo reigning champion, Sephiroth Ken, is going to come on. And we're going to do a Q&A with him. Chat, any question you have for Ken, will you please just start brainstorming right now? I have a ton of questions for Ken, and I'm going to ask him.
Keep it PG,
at
though.
At least one of them. Yeah, I guess we could go like R but no X, yeah?
Sure.
Yeah, no X-rated questions. So, there's that. Okay, so those are our guests for tonight. And then at 9 o'clock, the plan is that we build up. And we want to have. Can I do the first refresh? Is that the idea?
Go for it.
You want to do it? Let's
do it.
Well,
I already refreshed.
I mean, they've been posting it in the thread.
Yeah. So everybody
has
an idea.
But let's make it official for this moment.
Yeah. So, I have been refreshing. So it's not going to be like, oh, this is crazy. Oh, this is going to suck because now I have to do some exploit stuff. Everybody knows that I'm pretty bad with this, but I'll figure it out. Okay, so I have this document. We started at 43,000.
Oh my god, $43,000. Wow, okay. Yeah. We started at 43,000 like 504.69.
No, 43,504.43.
Okay.
So, gotta get that straight. Remember last time we did this, we were like, alright, we're starting at $3,000.
Yeah.
Let's build a. Woo! So we're starting at $43,000, just to keep that in perspective. It's insane. And last time I refreshed, and as Chad has been discussing for a while, we have, you know, beaten 45K, which is amazing. Last time I looked, it was 45.58. Thank you guys so much for your contributions. We still have 2,500 to go before we hit our official goal.
It's our matching goal.
Yeah.
You're the people's champion, right?
Last I checked.
Do you want to do something for the people?
Always.
I think I have a special guest lined up as well, you know.
Who would it be?
Some guy that we were talking about a bit earlier. I think Cactar kind of just made some of him. And a lot of people haven't seen him in a while, but they wonder where he's been, what he's doing.
Uh-huh.
Chat, would you guys want to see, I don't know, some homemade waffles guy in here tonight?
Oh, homemade waffles, Brandon. He's like the maker of what's it called? Wombo combo. Everybody spam wombo combo in the chat. Oh my god!
Oh.
All right. 45. Let's see where we are. Boom. Oh wow, that's a big jump. Woo! 47-149. Who did that in the past,
holy
like, 10 minutes?
Crap.
This is madness. This is blasphemy. This is madness.
So this has been $4,000 in an hour.
That's about right.
And so, we haven't put in our matching
we
yet.
Have not. So let's see what's been so far. Now minus start. Oh, going to type it in. Yeah, we have already in the past few moments, we have downloaded from the internet $3,500, which is the vast majority of our match. So we're well on our way to throwing the entirety of the Spirit Bomb into the pot. Our stretch goal, somebody was telling me, oh, you know, 10K, we could beat 10K tonight. 15 is the stretch goal. 15K from what we started is $62,000, which is a lot of money. So let's... If we got this, we got this.
I think we should try to get all our people who are matching, put it in like the span of, you know, 1 minute or something, so we can just see the insane jump.
Dude, 9 o'clock was my
hopefully.
Idea. Let's do it.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. 9 o'clock will be our massive spirit bomb from all our matchers and everybody else who wants to go in.
Yeah, so, exactly. I think that's
totally.
That's what I want to do. I don't know if everybody else wants to do it. Some people are... So a lot of people are worried about sniping. Okay, so my bigger fear is DDoS, right? My bigger fear... Yarok, if you can't contribute the match at 9 o'clock my time, or any of the matchers, please just send it to me through the chip-in. The chip-in is in the info section of this VGB stream, so you can just... Dude, my Excel is hella good, Neil. Sorry, I just looked at it.
Shout-outs to Neil.
Yeah, shout-outs to Neil DT, the super homie. So anyway, just do it through the chip-in. Let me know that it's you, and I will do that whole I'll-put-it-in thing. Sound good? Cool.
You know, while we have a couple minutes before AlphaZelle comes in, again, I just want to say with this still shrink-wrapped, pristine copy of the Hyrule Historia limited edition, 1 out of 4,000. If you donated previously or you're donating tonight, you're still available. I'm taking everything up until probably all emails up until we drop the Spirit Bomb. And then probably at about 12:30 AM, 9:30 on the West Coast, I will announce the winner of this.
Fantastic.
So email me, progducto@gmail.com. Same thing as my Twitter and all that stuff. So you can send me those emails, guys. I'm still going through them. You'll get a confirmation email from me.
Hey, and by the way, can I just say something? Can I say something really quickly? I want to ask. So a lot of people have not really seen the value in this website called Twitter. I'd like to sort of just say, you know...
Why don't you sell me on it?
Sure.
I'm, Twitter thing is... I'm pretty skeptical about this, so
yeah.
Why don't you sell me on it, Bobby?
So
I'm,
let's talk
I'm
about
listening.
Twitter for like a minute here. what are you saying?
I thought he was saying my name.
Sheridan? Oh! Okay.
Like, Sheridan!
So now let me just talk about Twitter for like a minute. Okay, so... We as a community are, like, getting pretty big. And there are certain people that, there's certain people that you kind of want to stay in touch with. You want to see, like, what they're doing. And most importantly, like, there are things that you want to tell the people that you care about. Things that you think are important. Like, hey, man, I just posted this thread on Smashboards, and, you know, I really want everybody to check it out. Like, I guess currently people really can't look at you and see exactly what you're posting and stuff like that. Not that you want to post every stream or every post, but certain ones you kind of want to promote. And then there's certain people, like me as a young noob, you know, maybe I want to talk to Ken. Maybe I want to talk to Isaiah. Oh, my God, how fucking cool would that be? I can tweet at Isaiah, and he can, like, you know, not feel pressure to have to, like, really reply to me. If you just retweet me, it's like, oh, Isaiah, I watched your combo video. Oh, you know, Silent Spectre, I watched Silence. It was pretty cool. He retweets me, and I feel great about myself. Point being, like, having a presence on a social media site that has the potential to reach outward is more powerful than what we do now, which is Facebook, which is when you join the group, you know, blah, blah, blah. I can hear myself. When you join the group, then you can see what's going on, but you can't really bring other people in. Same with Smashboards, where, like, we're kind of a, you know, a community. What is going on here, dude?
You good?
I don't know.
Somebody's doing something. Yeah, we're a community, and we go to the site and we see what other people say. But Twitter is an opportunity to sort of go out, and all the people who are following you can see what you're saying. Your other smashers, they can see, oh, this is blah blah blah. It's super cool. This looks amazing because you have like, you know, Russian friends who just learned to speak English. So I don't know if that was a compelling kind of thing. It's kind of stream of consciousness, but Twitter.
Yeah, I'm
pretty
not sold,
cool,
Bobby,
man. Twitter's pretty
but
cool.
Yes,
okay, Sheridan, like young noob in, you know, Delaware, who's like, man, I really
no,
want to
run
a tournament,
I'm just
and
messing.
I like, I need some help.
I'm just old and crotchety about it, but yeah,
I appreciate your old and crotchety attitude.
Yeah,
it's also pretty cool. Like earlier, like we were talking about Trihex and how much he's been doing with his streams. He was saying how like how huge of a fan he is of Armada. Armada hears about it through the I can't think of the term right now. Sheridan.
What's the term?
Through the grapevine.
Okay.
And and he ends up just making a Twitter account just to message him. So it's a way also just to acknowledge other people. So I mean, definitely a big fan of that.
I think it's That's about awesome. Time for AZ to come on.
You can follow him on Twitter as well.
So we're apparently, by the way, going to be on the front page at 8 p.m. So 8 p.m. we have to do something really sweet. So like 7:45, I feel like I'm going to be talking to you guys and being like, what would be awesome? What could we do that is awesome? I would love to rebroadcast MTK vs. Shiz 4 again. So Trihex did it, and Sophie was watching. Like literally Sophie knows very little about my age. You know, she watches every once in a while. She watched it manifest a little bit, but she gets tired really quickly. And you know, she was watching because Trihex is interesting and awesome. Trihex, like, I can't shout that guy so enough. He is, like, such a cool dude. I wish that he's going to Evo, so we're all going to chill because I'm going regardless. Blah, 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 blah. So Sophie, my fiance, girl, not into video games, is watching. And somebody's like, you know, what should we play? We want to show something that shows what competitive Melee is all about. People are like, oh! Actually, a lot of people are like, I kill Mufasa! And I was like, a lot of people are like, you know, that Yoshi combo video, it's sick! Put the axe effect on, blah, blah, blah. And then, like, I feel like one genius was just like, MTK Shiz 4, dude. And then the whole chat's like, MTK Shiz, MTK Shiz, MTK... And Trihex has never seen it, I bet, right? And he's just like, man, this whole chat's telling me this MTK Shiz 4, I'm just gonna type it into YouTube and play it. So he types it in, and like, let me tell you, I think I've already talked about this. I talk about MTK Shiz 4 as much as I can. This match is like every Smash star aligned, and it is the best, most perfect demonstration of competitive Melee. First of all, you have literally the two coolest people in the world on the mic. Mogwai, who's drunk, and Hazard, you know, the narrator, the Morgan Freeman of Melee,
yes,
also drunk, watching this incredible match between Mewtwo King's Marth, in my opinion, the most entertaining player to ever exist, especially versus Space Animals, versus the Shizwiz, who is another insane, like, blow-your-mind Space Animal, fan favorite, crowd favorite. So anyway, she sits down, she's watching this game, right? She just starts getting off. She's a whoop in M2K. It makes it look like Falco just destroys Marth. He's laser comboing and up smashing. And Falco, like, if you don't know about Melee, Falco's jumping in the air, coming down on you with his feet, blinking on you, and you pop up. He does some Dragon Ball Z stuff. He jumps so high. It's like, what is this guy doing? So, you know, he's doing, like, just generic drill shines. And Sophie's like, wow, this is, like, that is an amazing combo. Don't know what she's talking about, but it's cool to watch. Falco is really cool to watch.
Yeah, so I totally agree with that. Let's put on some hype matches.
Can I tell the rest of the story?
I have an idea.
Is that your whole story?
No,
you've
man,
been talking about this
better.
For like 5 minutes.
MTK Shiz 4 is the best example of.
All right. Wrap it up.
I'm wrapping it up. So now MTK is down. One stock to three. Sophie looks at it. She's like, man, you know what would be really cool? If M2K could kill the Shizwiz and win, because he's down by so much. And I just look at her and I'm like, that would be really cool. So, you know, we just watch the rest of it. You know, he gets the grab on the platform. Oh, Ken combo. Hey! And then everybody's screaming, and just Shiz runs over at M2K like an idiot, and does like the down air down smash, the desperation, I want this game to be over so bad. That's the grab, that's the down throw, and he just M2K poops on him. Mogwai goes, oh, ah! It was just perfect.
Okay, yeah.
That's the end of it, but it's a good story, so, you know, I wanted to tell it.
Let's go. Actually, I just had an idea as well.
Sounds good, dude. Let's
same
do it.
Thing. We could also have Waffles in here talking about that match between, I don't know, who was it? What's Silent Spectre and
Falcon Player, right?
Yeah, he's, and who was he teaming with?
For what? For Wombo Combo?
Think he had a teammate in Wombo Combo.
Who
I
was it?
I think he has been known to be called the best player in the world at times.
Yeah, that's true.
Mr.
Mitchell?
Mitchell Tang.
Is that the one?
Is that Mitchell?
It was Mitchell Tang.
They were up against that guy from Jersey who's actually from California.
Who is actually also amazing, and I wish that we could cheer his name more often.
It's where little kids go look at animals.
He's not from New Jersey.
All right, AZ's ready. I'm pulling him in. We can keep talking about this, but that's...
I think he's from Jersey.
No, he's from Canada.
Really?
I think he's originally from Canada and then moved to NorCal. Moved to NorCal when he was younger, I believe. But he's going to move to that area.
Okay.
Alpha Zealot, you here?
Someone.
What's up, guys?
Alpha Zealot and his camera! He breaks out the webcam so we can see his face. 3 out of 5 people now we can see.
Right, yeah, don't that's be
a
really scared,
would have been 4 if, you know, there weren't a crucial mistake on a certain day last week, but
whoa,
moving
on. Whoa, okay.
I'll accept.
What's up? How you doing?
It's been a long week, but I'm very happy that we're still in the lead.
Yeah, as are we. So, Alpha Zealot, you have given us a great opportunity here. You know, we talked about something maybe 2 weeks ago. We were talking about, you know what, it would be great if you guys and, like, the community at large worked as a team and built something that we all love and that we're all passionate about. And then all of a sudden, I get this PM in my inbox from Alpha Zealot, GM and owner of Smashboards. And it says, hey, Scar, remember you talked about that thing? Guess what? We're going to do it. So AZ has this dope mock-up, which is, of course, not final, right? It's nothing that we're going to say, oh, you know, blah, 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 you know, they wasted all this time on the blah, blah, blah. It's either, you know, whatever it is, we're going to get to take a look at it in this infancy form, just like a little baby Captain Falcon. And it depends on how Mama and Dad and Papa Captain Falcon raise him. He can either be the Douglas J we all know and love, or, you know, I don't know where I'm going with this, but...
Right. I guess the important thing is... and I've sent you the link, Scar, if you could push that into the chat or something. I don't know if you already have or not, but...
Did you link to it?
I just pushed this up on Smashboards into our announcement discussion like 5 minutes ago. And so it's viewable for everyone if you're at home right now at your computer, which you must be because you're listening to me talk right now. You can go ahead and check it out. It's what we call a wireframe. It's organization, it's layout, it's what content we want on there. If you notice something missing or if you think we're giving too much focus to one thing or another, that's the type of commentary we'd like to know. And then the big thing is we're sort of debating, once we get to the aesthetic part of it, whether to go with sort of a darker style or a lighter style. Smashboards, given our history, we probably want dark because we wouldn't want to go to something and be completely unfamiliar with it. But anyways, check it out. I'm sure Scar just posted the link. And we'd love to hear commentary.
I didn't yet. But
well, I can do that for you.
Well, someone can post a link, right?
Dude, do you have a way to, like, take your stuff and just be like, everybody has to look at this now? Or do I have to, like, know how to use a forum and actually navigate to announcements?
Right, so click on announcements at the very top of the forum, and it'll be right there at the top of the list. We can do what we've been doing for the last 2 weeks, which is putting up on the front page something, you know, right now it's the donate button.
Absolutely.
Actually, it's the link to this stream. So we can do that, but I prefer not to we use that space for really, really important things. And as much as I want people to comment on the wireframe, this sort of donation campaign has been top priority. And so we've been trying to spotlight that.
Awesome.
The unfortunate timing is a little bit in terms, is that it's overshadowing some of the other things we're doing. Bionic announced a few days ago, for example, that we've purchased Zenforo for our new form software.
Yeah.
We are now working on that. We have it on a dev staging area, so that's slowly being worked on. Wireframes being worked on. So our six-month timeline that I sort of outlined at the end of February is holding, barely. But hopefully we will be in place pretty well, or pretty good.
So everybody who's, take a look at the stream or just navigate over to Smashboards on your own. Let's. Why don't you take me on a tour through this? Are you big on selling things? Do you want to give me the run, or do you want me to talk about what I see as a player? We could do it either way.
Yeah, I guess I'll give you the rundown.
Tell us the story of what it's like. I'm a Smasher. I'm so excited about this game, and I navigate my way to Smashboards.com.
Okay. Well, first thing you'll notice is obviously when you go to Smashboards, your forums has been replaced with a homepage design, much like Shoryuken or 8-Way Run or Smash for You. With that comes the need for content and spotlighting the community and the different things that are out there. I still find that sort of news articles, news stories is the best way to sort of get the message out with things. So your front page content, that sort of feature section, if you've got the wireframe pulled up in front of you right now, that's going to highlight whatever's happening in the community right now. So if we were, for example, doing this stream right now, that would be on the front page, front and center. You wouldn't get just a line of text now. You'd have an image, an article, something written about it to describe it. The next major thing that I'd like to highlight is sort of the featured tournament section. Tournaments will no longer be relegated to, again, just text. We're going to bring in visual or imageries. A lot of the tournament organizers out there now are producing graphics for the tournaments. Well, now we can highlight that. You can create
awesome.
Your banner for your tournament. You can quickly identify whether it's Brawl, Melee, Project M, Smash 64. We put those little icons with the tournaments, and we can highlight up to six different tournaments. Two of them would be more brought out than others, and then the other four would also have a very big section. Directly to the right of that, though, is a calendar. This calendar will go to an area where all of the events, and we do have a calendar system right now, by the way, but this would go to something a little more fully fleshed out, streams, tournaments, anything that's going on, you can add it to the calendar system. And this is now on the main page, so you always know there's something happening in the Smash community. Sandwiched sort of near that calendar is our live streams. Right now we're only featuring five live streams, two of them more predominantly than the other three. Mm-hmm. I've had some comments on it already, so we may change that layout just a little bit, but it's looking like the goal is to put the more important or the better produced ones towards the top. The bottom three may have a situation where we randomly select, and depending on when you refresh the page, there might be a different stream in there or not. Because, for example, last weekend, there were 9 live streams last Saturday.
Yeah. I actually did see it. Actually had to expand, right? Because there were so many. Took up half of the real estate.
Right. So there's a problem there, though, because we don't want the page to stretch or look awkward. But we also don't want to not put content on the page that's out there.
Yeah.
So trying to figure out that right medium or right middle ground where we can feature the better ones or the ones that are really produced, and the ones that are not can still get some face time so no one's left out in the cold is really the key there.
Do you want me to solve this problem for you right now?
Sure.
Are you ready for this? Prog, are you ready for this?
I'm never ready for anything.
Okay, Sheridan, you tell me if this is the best idea in the world. This is
all
my.
Right, I'm ready. I'm ready just to completely destroy it.
Yeah. By the way, this is like Scar best idea in the world number 37, and I always ask Sheridan, "Hey, is this the best idea in the world or what?" Because he'll tell me. AZ, check this out, right? So what you essentially want to do is you want to surface the live streams that that are like the highest quality. So it's sort of like, you know, what people want to see, you want to show them. And that's subjective. It depends on the user. So would it be cool or would it not be cool for me as a user to be able to tell Smashboard somehow, and I know it's going to take a little bit of work, right, but to follow people like Johnny, right? I think S2J is the man. You know, I want to watch everything that Mango does. I want to watch Mutant King matches, so on and so forth. And if that tournament or that live stream features that player, you know, there's some logic that'll show that to me disproportionately. So also
think,
with like regional,
I think that would be really easy to do. You just have like tags that you could follow or something.
I love it.
And
man,
then that, you know, the news item or whatever thing pops up gets a bunch of tags. And if one of your, you know, favorites is in that, then it comes to you, you know, in your some kind of news feed or email or something like that.
Sheridan, 1 to 10, best idea in the world.
How about, well, I mean, you're competing against the rest of ideas in the history of time. So, I mean, I'll give you like 6.5.
So like a solid good idea.
Pretty good. I think solid, that's pretty good. Idea.
Okay. You know what?
I think it's okay, but I would point out that that's basically what Facebook does with your friends. The ones you care about filter towards the top, and the one you haven't checked on in 3 years, you'll never see ever, even though they're still posting news updates. Okay, but I think it's a good idea.
We need
to look into it. Like all things, development time is going to be the hardest thing. Our next stage, once we have the wireframe completely finished, is we need to recruit developers. We're going to be looking within the community. We're going to be starting some sort of room where we give developers access to what they would need to help basically put this wireframe together and make it into an actual site. That's the most scary part for me, and we'll see what happens and how that turns out. sorry, I'm battling a little bit of a cold right now. I guess the last thing I want to touch on, or the last two things, I mean, there's a lot of stuff going on this page, and I don't want to bore everyone, so if you got to check it out if you want to really give me your critiques. I want to make sure to read everything that's written. But in the meantime, just below your live streams are your videos. I preferably want to set those to Apex Just Happens while we put up the grand finals of Melee, of Brawl, of Project M. We feature those for a week.
Yeah.
Bam, ROM happens. Put up the grand finals or the winner's finals or that really hype matchup. We put a spotlight on those YouTube videos because a lot of times I think we're still not highlighting them as good as we could.
But
the big thing there is that not only do you highlight the people who produce the videos, but you're highlighting our great, great players, those guys who, you know, dedicate themselves and put thousands of hours into the game, tens of thousands in Melee's case at this point. So that's the goal, sort of that right bar. Most of it is video media. And then the last section I'd really like to point out, because it's something you guys just talked about, follow on Twitter. We're going to get writers. I'd like that section to sort of highlight people who do content, people who stream, people who are, you know, do a lot of things for the community, because typically it's not the most, I don't want to say a thankless task to do awesome things, but, you know, people can do more to get their names out there. We can do more to spotlight the people who do things for the community. And Twitter is a tool we have not been using as well as other communities. We need to step our game up. There's no reason. Not even like most Smashers are like, you know, Mewtwo Kings or your, you know, Mangos and Dr. PP. There's not any of them that have over 1,000 followers, right?
Right.
They should have 10,000 followers.
Yep.
Right. So part of that's because we're not using Twitter. I don't know. If you're not on Twitter yet, hop on Twitter. Get on Twitter if you're listening to this stream. Start following Scar. I'm sure he's posted his Twitter somewhere or another, right? Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Okay. Bobby's Car. You can follow me at Bobby's Car.
Right. Right. So that would be the other thing, too. When news stories are up there, we can try and highlight, you know, the Twitter handle of who did it. We have a featured section that's going to pull, or featured discussion that we'll pull also directly from the forums. So whatever that hot topic is, like donating to Melee for Evo right now, that would be, you know, pulled straight from the forums and put up on the homepage. So you'd still be able to get those quick links to the hot topics on the forum, or, and, you know, try and keep some of that forum sense on the homepage. I mean, it's going to be a hard switch. I mean, the day that this goes live, after you'd been, or in my case, looking at Smashboards as a forum for 10 years, and then one day you come on as a homepage and not a forum, it's going to be really awkward. it's going to be a tough switch. I hope the community can bear with us as we go through it, but I think in order for us to progress as a community and for Smashboards to give people what they want, we ultimately need to make this switch over from a forum to something more content-driven and community-driven. And so, yeah.
No, and actually, since we're talking about Twitter, I just want to shout out Shloka again over in the French scene, who not only has a personal Twitter for himself, but does tournament updates for the entire French scene on Twitter as well.
All right.
On
nice.
A separate Twitter as well. So.
I think the Alabama Smash community has a Twitter as well. They have a really organized community there. I followed ages ago, and every once in a while I'm on, and they're like, oh, they're tweeting something. Okay, cool. But there's a lot. I tried a year ago, to try and make a list and get everyone on Twitter, but it's so hard to keep up with it. Because people are always coming on, and then people kind of don't sign on for a while, and so where'd they go, you know? And Twitter can be a little fickle like that. So get on there, start tweeting, start following people. I would suggest following things you're interested in. That includes news. Tech sites are awesome to follow, because then you can always stay on top of like what's happening in the gaming world.
Oh, yeah. And you know what I think we should do? Prog, can we do this? Can we make a Melee list?
Well, actually, you know, I was gonna mention some guy named D1, who we were talking yesterday about all these Smashers who are using Twitter. And why don't we do like a Follow Friday where you can search by, I don't know, are these players you want to follow? Here's a list, and we'll have them all being retweeted over and over again.
Follow Friday.
So just make it easy for everyone to follow.
Follow Friday, guys. So now you heard it here first. Today's Thursday, so tomorrow is Prog.
Follow Friday.
If you want to use Twitter for the express purposes of getting in touch with players you care about and knowing more about Melee, today is the day to do it. So you donate your $5, create a Twitter account, and you're basically the coolest dude in the Melee community for that minute. Boom.
Actually, speaking of, in the interest of this whole donation stuff, you know, I've been reading a lot about what people have been saying and everything, and I keep hearing or I keep seeing on, like, say, SRK that, you know, we had our shot or something or other, and we weren't very awesome, or I don't know what it was back in the day, but there's a couple of things I've pulled up, and if you guys wouldn't mind, would you want to hear what people actually thought back in 2007 when Melee was at Evo?
Ooh, 2007. I'm down.
I would love to hear that.
Sure.
Yeah.
All right. So one of these quotes is Glenn Cravens. He had a site called Mighty News.
I know Glenn pretty well.
Get your tournament.
All right. So here's his description of Melee for 2007. He says, the crowd at Evo's Championship Sunday was emotionally drawn in from the start to the finish. Nearly 1,000 people were in the building, and they went crazy when Mango upset Ken in the first match of the Final Eight. Then in the final moments of the championship, the crowd was chanting, hugs, hugs, as he tried to hold on to that final stock. By then, the crowd was 1,200 people. About 1,200 people going for one guy. I had never heard that before anywhere in any game. To hear it at a tournament where many people thought Melee was their dinner break was amazing. So, that's my first quote.
Amazing. That's a great
what do you guys
quote.
Think?
I love
yeah?
that quote.
That's fantastic.
It's pretty monstrous.
Right. Right. And then the other one, this is probably too much for people to read, for me to read out loud. I want to share that link with the chat, Scar.
From James Chen.
Yes, so James Chen back in 2007 wrote about Melee, and he more or less, let's see. I will skip part of it, but he goes on to say that the Smash community has a game that some people frown upon. As a brand new community added to the Evo lineup, the Smash Bros. Players had every reason to come in very skeptical and behave very poorly. But instead, they decided to prove why they deserve respect and why they deserve to remain at future Evolution tournaments. The players came out in droves. They became instantly one of the largest tournaments in Evo in terms of number of contestants. I believe Melee was the second biggest tournament that year, by the way. Players showed up for pools on time. They were extremely cooperative to whoever was running the brackets. There wasn't even a big stink, and he goes into some little side trail here. And I don't know. You have to read the whole thing. He goes on for another two paragraphs. Point being that I see people saying how Melee didn't do good the first time it was there, and that's just not the case. People who were there and everyone that wrote about it afterwards, Melee, the community, everyone listening now, know that the people before you kicked ass.
And that's very good to know.
even more recently, you know, after Apex, we had Ultra David, Yipes, Skasonic all touting the Smash games as well. So things haven't changed that much. We just have to show that's the case.
Right. Yeah, the community is great. I try and keep that in mind, too, because I don't know who's going to win this thing at the end, whether Melee gets sniped or not, but we're doing this for a great cause. Don't lose sight of that. And, you know, I worry a little bit at the aftermath. This is not the end of Melee if things don't happen the way some people want.
I would love to know if anybody's actually worried about that, by the way, because I'm so confident and so excited. Like, this whole thing has just not only, like, it's been a rejuvenating kind of experience.
Right. Well, I mean, from my perspective, there is some worry. I mean, if Melee's not in or if it is in, I mean, I've done the math in the past at how many tournaments there are in a year and that sort of thing, and I mean, you can usually expect for Melee somewhere between 1 and 200,000 spent on tournaments in a year, depending on whether it's an up or down year. So to see 45,000 get put towards a donation is awesome, or 50 or 60 or whatever it ends up being tonight. but, you know, that's a fourth or half of what Mike has spent in a whole year. So a lot of this for me will be looking at the aftermath and seeing if the community can handle victory or defeats maturely. I mean, remember that when you talk about Smash, unfortunately, everyone is a representative of the community ultimately, so try to put your best face forward if you're on Shoryuken, or I don't even know where Skullgirls goes to. Shoryuken, I think.
They're on SRK for now. They are developing their own forums as well.
Yeah. And if anyone from Skullgirls is listening, you guys need to get your own forums, because the reason Smash is so awesome is because we didn't integrate into Evo and the Shoryuken, you know, mindset of we're one community with the Smash or the fighting game community. We are one Smash community. And I mean, if you looked at Evo's 2007 lineup, the only game on there that's still holding tournaments on a regular basis is Melee. So you got to get your own community going, because that's the only way you're going to keep a history and keep people playing and keep people interested.
Yeah, that's kind of something that I was saying too, right? There's different investments that you can make, and I think that, you know, everything starts with community. So, cool.
Yeah, it's hard to say, though, because, you know, you might miss some crossover audience from other fighting games.
Yeah.
Which there's more of between.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, you know, we have the same thing, right? But I mean, just to say that, like, it's not an all or nothing kind of thing. It's not like, oh,
certainly,
we're putting everything that we have in this one moment. I feel like Melee, just as a game, has sort of just appealed to us over the years, and also, you know, the more we've invested in each other, you know, speaking of TOs, right, and held awesome tournaments and cared about the tournament experience, the bigger we've grown.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I think that any game community that really cares about their game and a game that gives back, Melee gives back, man. If Skullgirls gives back, you guys are going to be totally fine.
Yeah, I've been super impressed with everyone. I don't think they'll ever show us the numbers, but I think if you were to take our total and divide by the number of donors, I don't think that number would be very high. I think we have a lot of people donating a little, and not a little amount of people donating a lot. You know, $10 here, $15 here, $30 here, whatever it is. You know, there was that 4K donation that turned out to not be a donation. So, I mean,
nobody knows.
Nobody.
Wait,
knows.
I thought it was still in the. It's still
there.
Pool,
money didn't come out. We right. just don't know who did it.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, we know.
If Mr. Wizard or whoever at EVO was running this was smart, they should probably not announce the winners for a couple of days because, like when I donated, it took I think 3 or 4 days for it actually to show up on my credit card.
Uh-huh.
So.
That's true because yeah, I see what you're going. Yeah, some people's might not go through. So.
Right. The smart thing for Mr. Wizard or for them would be to wait several days to make sure all charges clear, and then to make an official announcement. That's just my guess. I mean, if I were doing it, I'd rather be safe because I think ultimately whoever wins this thing tonight to beat cancer, the difference will be only a few thousand dollars, and that's not much. I mean, it could be even less than that. Who knows?
Yep.
Awesome. Barring some $50,000 snipe from some guy in Japan that I heard might happen. But.
Yeah, we heard about it, but not worried, man.
Yeah.
Believe it when I see it.
Right.
And the other thing is, you know, that would be awesome for BCRF, and, you know, we've already done an amazing job, so I'm just not worried about it at all.
All right, well, guys, before I sign off here, because I know you want Bionic on, 3-4 weeks ago now, you made a podcast wondering what we were doing with Smashboards. Are you guys happier now?
I think that's a huge step in the direction that, you know, I personally wanted to go in. You know, it seems to me that people are excited to see what's going on. You know, I feel like the thread that you made will definitely get a feel for whether or not this is what your audience actually does want, but it's definitely what I want to see. I just want to work together, man. When we talk about one unit, that's like, you know, I think that if we as a community feel that we're all working together, you know, our hub needs to be a part of that community. And we aren't a result of the site. The site rather is, you know, kind of like part of who we are. So, you know, if we keep working together, if we talk, if we hang out, if we're friends, it's going to be great.
All right. Great. Well, everyone listening, thank you, and great job. Keep up the good work, everyone. I hope the Spirit Bomb is a success. So far, it looks great. I cannot believe we're at the numbers that we're at. It's, that's really insane. check out the wireframe if you get a chance. Keep on Smashboards. I cannot believe our server has not crashed yet from tonight. So good job to the Temple host keeping us up somehow. Good stuff. All right.
Good stuff, man. Thanks for coming on.
Thank you.
Yep. Thank you for having me.
I'll catch you later, bro.
Yep.
And you know what? AZ was completely on giving back, because that's what we need to do. So speaking of, I have this Hyrule Historia limited edition, 1 out of 4,000 copies, leather bound, golden pages. You know, it was $70 already on eBay going for $300. And I had to wait in the snow for 2 hours for this. You can ask G-Money, you can ask G1. They know I was out there in the snow. And I'm just going to give it away to someone by the end of the night. But, you know, I can't just give that away with, you know. I used to play a bit of World of Warcraft back in my day. I played a rogue, so I know all you guys want to dual wield these little master swords. And of course, for all the children in your lives, or even, you know, if you got your Crayolas, those like box 16 that'll break. So you got the rose art instead, your first day of kindergarten. I have these little coloring pages, and, you know, have you seen this link? It looks like Ultima Scout's link. Depending on how you color it. I mean, I can't tell if it's Internet Explorer, Lord HDL, Smurfy. There's so many links it could be, and it's up to you to draw it. That one person who gets both of these. So,
well, those again, sound
guys,
like
go ahead and email
opportunities.
Me.
Can we have the finished result featured somehow so that everybody can see what they do with those?
Yes, I would love to see that. But, yeah, it could be Scler. But go ahead and email me if you've donated 20 or more, and I will go ahead and enter you in the running. For those that want to know, we are a bit above 250 entrants at this point. That's huge. So shouts to all of you guys. But only one can win. And
there can only be one.
And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to read my copy because I have a standard edition. I didn't even get the limited for myself.
Wow.
The limited's going out for someone else. I have my standard right here. So, that being said, I think we might be ready for... Scar, what's next?
I was just going to say, you know, hey guys, we're doing an amazing job so far. I'd love to do a refresh right now. It's not over until it's over. Something that
and even
I...
Even then, it may not be
And even then, it may not
over.
Be over.
Yeah.
It's never over.
So, yeah, I want to do our second, I think, refresh. Yeah?
Yeah, let's see it.
All right, guys. So I think I may have been refreshing in the meantime. I'm actually not sure. Just because
we started at $43,504 or something like that.
We started at $43,504. Last time I checked, it went up from this 47 by 1.5K. So let's do another refresh. We're at 48.5, and this is probably 48.6. That is fucking astounding. We're also in this number not counting what is in the chip-in.
That's right.
So... Oh! There you go.
Carry
we have... Woo! We have hit the amount of money for which the full spirit bomb that we've been charging up will be
that
thrown.
Spirit bomb's going to hit at 9 p.m. So all you matchers and anybody else that wants to get in on it... Donate at 9 p.m. and we're gonna blow this website away. It's just gonna be insane. We're gonna have a huge jump, and I want everybody to be there for that.
And yeah. Just because we hit the amount doesn't mean that we're asking you to stop, guys. Because we are still in this. You know,
absolutely.
DA Dave, everyone knows his famous words: "One stock is not a lead. This is not a lead." Period. Keep it up, guys. I'm very, very proud of what you guys have been doing and all the effort you've been putting in. So.
That's right. We're going to take this. We're going to be streaming all the way till the end. So we'll just keep on, you know, after the spirit bomb, we're going to still need more. So just keep on watching and donating if you can. So I think now we're going to have Biona come on. Is that right?
Yeah. I want to see if he's available. So we're also in talks with someone who is has been donating tons of money, the Peach D Smash of donations, Sean Frost. Frog, what is his tag, by the way?
Nova.
No? Yeah, it's Nova. I was going to say, but I don't want to be wrong. And so he's wondering how he could stretch his money as far as he can. So I was thinking, if you're listening, and MTK I know is listening, what he could do is he could say, if he's got, you know, some amount of money, let's say... I don't know, $2,000. How could he stretch this as far as possible? Because we already hit our match amount. What he could do is he could say, you know what? I want to be one of those guys who does a match. So, Sean, if you're listening, MTK, if you're listening, he could pledge that money, and if the community donates $5,000, then he throws in the whole thing. And if we donate less, then he'll throw in less. So it's an incentive to all of us, you know, and... To sort of step up and match him, and at the same time he gets that kind of commitment from other players to hit a certain amount. So that stretches his money a little bit further. I would recommend that. If he just wants to throw in the money, that's totally cool too, because we're doing a great job. So, with that said, we got another homie who is going to come in and talk to us. You guys ready for this?
I'm ready.
Cactus, are you ready?
I am so ready.
Oh, and Brandon's ready? Dude, Brandon, you should hit me up on Skype.
I think let's do that. Let's do that like after we get on the front page. Like we'll show M2K Shiz and then do Wombo Combo and have him on talking about it, and then we'll have Ken.
Wombo Combo! Boom! Bionic, you're on the show. What's up, homie?
Good. Let's see if I can get a screen share working. Was it working group calls?
Yeah, it's working, my man.
No, screen share. Share screens. Here we go. Start. Now, you can see this, right?
Dude, what are you doing?
Yeah, I see two of you now.
There's two of you.
Oh my god, he's doubling.
Free Ice Climbers! They're free!
Okay, so try clicking on
All right, hang on.
The desktop thing.
You gotta hang on real quick. Add Skype video. Maximize this shiz. Boom!
All right. This is our development site so far. We purchased, as AZ mentioned before, we purchased it about a week ago on Sunday. And here's the history of the whole thing began. I've known a friend. He goes by Forsaken. I've known him since I was 12. And he's really up on all the software and everything. And back in March 2011, I ask him something formally, and he says, "Have you seen Zemfuro?" And I say, "No." And he shows me all this stuff, saying, by the time they get to like 1.0, it's going to be great." So I start looking into it, and by April 2011, I actually proposed to the Senate going to Zemfuro. And, you know, 21 months later, here's what's happening. Now, this is basically the basic. It's probably not going to look like this. First off, you have the logo right here. It's going to be the Smashboard logo, but it is going to be fluid width. Now, this is the front page. I'm not logged in, so I'm showing everything from a user or guest side. And I've actually invited a lot of the Smashboard's staff to give me feedback. That's how, my bad. When you click on category, it's not its own page. It just goes to a specific thing on the category. But you click on a forum, and this is how the forum looks. Now, you can sort by title, sort by start date, just by click, last message, John2K4 7 minutes ago. You also have more options here, just like Smashboards, first message likes, whoever has the... And that's one of the things I'll go into for a second. Here's how basic topic works. You have your thread title here. You have your post. And the user titles are basically going to be in ribbons. And I think username colors might be going away. But custom titles, they'll be a little bit longer. One of the things I mentioned earlier, liking posts, this is basically plus one, or I agree, or I like this idea. This was actually very controversial. I don't know how a lot of people feel about it. When I brought it up to the staff about a month ago when we told them we were switching to Zemfuro, they were split on it. Some of them didn't like them. Some of them loved them. So we're going to try it there. Let me go into searching forums first. All right, so you know how you can search Bionic or Scar or MutaKing, but you can't really search Bio, Lux, John.
Oh, M2K knows all about it, dude. M2K has been struggling with this for his life.
So one of the things you can do with search is now three character searches. Well, I haven't really enabled that yet, but
it's a work in progress.
it's a work in progress. What we are doing. Also, with the new search software that we have on here, it's called Enhanced Search. Enhanced. It means the 30-second limit for searching is also away. You can search your content.
That is so amazing.
And that was one of the things with vBulletin, because searching would be the slowest thing, the slowest site. And with this Enhanced Search, Elastic Search, that's the name of the software of it, that's basically removed. And you can search anything. You can search keywords posted by a member and search profile posts. And what's new is basically what recent threads have been posted. I think there's something similar on Smashboards already. This is just, it's going to exist. User albums, these are still a work in progress too. These are going to, right now on Smashboards, you have the Brawl albums where you can upload .bin files from your SD card, like pictures you take in Brawl or Project M, and this is going to be a user album that is going to sit as viewable from your profile. Create an album, you can view your own album. The blog system is basically, it's not in a forum anymore. So, you know, in user blogs, it's basically Drupal, and right now it doesn't really look appealing because it's just a forum. And right now it's even broken. Whenever you make a new post, that's what you get. And right here, you can just click blogs. Here are the recent blogs here. You can click click any of them. Lorem Ipsum, blog entry, more from the author. And you can even like blogs. And even comments. You can even like the comments, but they're basically similar to like the Smash News comments. You can also add about the author. Mick is an Aussie of pure awesomeness and not leading a subtle Australian takeover of Smashboards. Events are just going to be like SRK type, Smash for You, RSVP, Omni's Party, whatever. That's weird. Got the media. And see if we can log in here. Because what I'm about to demonstrate. Now, as I mentioned before, you could watch a thread and you could receive email notifications, not receive, you have alerts. It basically tells you when a person likes your posts, when somebody else posts things. You have your user bar up here. This is not going to be visible to everybody, sorry. But you have you can update your status here. Scar's podcast is awesome.
Huh.
Or you can also game over, yeah. Also sit here.
Dude, what is Game Over, yeah? I feel like I'm a noob for not knowing.
Dude, okay, so in this game, I think it's called Sega Rally.
Uh-huh.
Like, whenever you lose, like, it doesn't give you just a Game Over screen. It's got, like, a little kind of ditty that goes, and when it plays, it goes, Game Over, yeah! And it's just fantastic.
Dude, your singing voice is beautiful, by the way. Pretty sick, man.
Thank you.
Say your location, occupation, homepage, about you. Just gonna put some stuff there. Save it. You don't even have to leave the page. You also have your news feed, in which the people you follow. Now, there's gonna be a friend system, there's gonna be a follow system. You can follow a person, and I'll follow Twinkie real quick, have them as an example, Jumpy Coon. Now I follow him, and you look in your news feed, and it'll tell you, you know, he's replied to thread, and there are privacy settings where you can also disable it so you don't have to tell your friends, you know, you like this status, you posted in this thread. You can set your signature here, whatever you want, again. Yeah. Your alerts, which is similar to Facebook notifications page, you know, like your post has fallen you, has added you, has commented on your blog, contact details, watch threads.
Dude, bio. I don't mean to cut you off. So these are awesome features, and this is looking like a pretty dope site. Do you know exactly where you are? Could we? I'm running out of time because we did too much with AZ. Do you think we could do this again and post it on YouTube?
Yeah.
So that's like the first half, and I can splice that first half and the second half, and then it'll be the full fucking thing.
Yeah.
Dude, how are you feeling? Are you pretty juiced about this? You having fun playing around with Zen4O? Do you feel like, you know, you're going to have a great time with it?
Hell, in a week, I might be done.
Look at this. Wow. This guy, dude. Big hand for Bionic.
So is the... So, because, you know, on Facebook, everybody's got these, you know, the Melee groups, right? Do you think... Is the goal to kind of... to move that discussion more into Smashboards? Or is there some stuff that this is going to do that Facebook's not going to be able to do and vice versa?
My aim is that, although if I'm trying to make it more accessible mobily too. We're adding social groups where there's already a Tap a Talk forum, and we're making a mobile style. Social groups are basically forum style, and I don't know. I have some stuff, like, I don't like how the Facebook is like, you have a 1,000 reply thing, and if you want to find something that's car posted, you would have to click view previous.
Yeah.
And with this, like, you can make your own social group, like NorCal Smashers, and whatever you want to do.
Sick, dude. Hey, Bionic, thanks so much for coming on, man. I'm sorry we didn't have more time, but we'll definitely... I'm going to get you on, and we're going to do some YouTube stuff. We're getting so close to 8 o'clock that I want to hype things up and get some sick matches playing. Do you have a request?
Yeah.
Not really.
Dude, I would actually say
Dark Rain versus Mango from Melee FC.
All right, man. So, can you stop sharing your screen? I don't know. I don't know how to do anything.
I don't know either.
actually, I figured it out. Okay. Yeah, thanks again, bro. It was great having you on. It's always great having you on. I hope you heard the shout for all of your amazing work. Thanks so much for promoting the drive, the stream. You know, we really appreciate it. And we know that you're kind of in the background, you know, doing all the heavy lifting. So from the bottom of my heart, thanks, bro.
Yep, follow me.
Thank you, Bio.
_Isitis.
There it is. You know where to follow him. All right, guys. Peace, Bionic. Talk to you soon.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Boom. Here we are, just us again. And I decided that I'm going to show one of my favorite combos right now.
Wait,
just
call
one combo.
What? I know a really, really good combo, too.
Dude, what?
Like, how about two Master Swords?
No way.
Two coloring pages.
Not even. I can't believe this is true.
And
the limited edition Hyrule Historia, still shrink wrapped, 1 out of 4,000. It's like, oh my, wombo combo.
Unreal. So now I'm gonna add a screen region. See, but now I can't get the chat and the screen region and our faces. Like, I want to look at our faces, man. It's like so cool.
Scar, is this Falco?
That ain't Falco. Whoa! Ah! You guys ready for this? Cactus, are you ready for this?
I'm ready for this.
Oh my god. Does everybody know this video?
Oh yeah, I know this video.
Oh no. No, I'm ruining it. There's no stopping me. Alright, I'm pausing it. Everybody hang on just 1 second, because it needs to be full fucking screen. And
while that's going on, again, thank you all for tuning in.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, come on. You know, like, it even needs to be said.
It need to hear it. Just thank you all.
You guys,
let's just say you all. Am I from the South?
Come on. If you've never seen the husband combo, this is the moment. How scary is this guy? Let's find out.
Oh, the days when Mushroom Kingdom 2 was a stage.
This is a turtle. Oh! Oh! Did that really happen? Down air grab? Don't stop me now. I'm having such a good time. One more time, come on. Let me just see this down air grab. Has that ever happened since?
I've never seen anything like that.
Husband, you are being remembered.
What?
Oh my shit. What was that? Nobody knows. So that's kicking it off. Let's take some additional requests for amazing, infinitely cool games. So, of course, MGK Shiz is going to happen. We are going to watch it with our eyes.
Pew Pew You versus Bam.
Oh, that was actually a sick set.
I didn't see that set. I would like to see that.
Got to load them up. Do we want to? Why don't? Should we talk about them while they're going on? Should we get people on and talk about
sure.
it?
Sure. Yeah, except I can't. Yeah. I can't see them in your time as you're watching them.
Yeah, I know.
So
yeah, unless we use SyncTube. But I mean, we have what, like 4 or 5 minutes until Homemade Waffles pops on. We can get them in here now.
Get them on
I guess.
Now. Yeah, you want to get Brandon in here now?
Yeah, do you guys want to see Homemade Waffles? Press one.
Dude, is this a real thing? The game is not. I've never seen this.
What's a real thing?
The game is not over. Dude.
Oh, yeah.
People are...
Yeah.
Is it amazing?
Probably.
Actually,
I don't remember.
You know that was a really good combo video that a lot of people slept on?
What?
Lord's combo video.
Oh, amazing. Dude, the 2012 in review or whatever that was?
Yeah.
Dude, that was fantastic.
Is Kevin vs. Bam only on handheld?
I don't know. It was posted in the Facebook group. Is that where you're looking at it?
PewDiePie, Marth vs. Bam, Falco. I just YouTube searched, dude.
That's
pretty good. It's pretty good. We could do it. Brandon, if you are in Skype, you have to add me, or if you're already buddies with one of these guys, you can message them and come on. Come on down. Hey, by the way, we should also talk about what we're doing after 9 o'clock. Now is a beautiful time to do an amazing refresh, by the way.
Scar, also invite Violence to the chat.
Yeah, you got to Skype him.
What, right now?
Well, whenever. Whenever you want to get Brandon in here, because Brandon's in his hotel room.
Eric Lee, why are they in a hotel room?
Because that's where Violence is staying right now.
All right. Brandon and Violence... We're throwing you in, my friends. It's time. Has anybody ever watched StarCraft 2? Artosis is always saying, "It's time.
Oh,
it's time, Tasteless."
Dude. Well, hold up. Let me get the video on.
What's up, Eric?
Riot was a fucking.
Yo.
Got Aces is bitch. Air out. Ball call.
Wow. I'm gonna throw you guys off because there's no microphone, dude. This
all right,
is
I'm visiting from Canada this weekend, and I was roaming the streets of San Francisco, and I happened to find Homemade Waffles. And as soon as we got on this call, he just had a phone call to answer. So he's gonna be right back. Sorry for killing the hype.
Dude, I'm actually gonna throw you out.
How are you guys doing tonight?
Will you, Eric, go out right now and buy a microphone. I will add you back to the call in 30 minutes.
Wait, go out and buy a microphone. You guys can't hear me.
I want you to get in the elevator.
I can hear you.
Go down to the first floor, walk to your car, and drive to a place that has a computer microphone.
All right. I'll get a microphone. All right, I'll be back.
I'll pay you back.
All right.
Goodbye.
That's how we operate.
Getting it done. Let's go. This is Melee.
Is Waffles one of those kinds of guys where, like, you wouldn't be surprised no matter where he was telling that story from right now? Like, oh, I was walking down the streets of Vegas and there was Waffles. Oh, I was walking around in Philly. There's Waffles. Is he that kind of guy?
I think so.
No, actually, one place I didn't see Waffles was when I was waiting in line at Nintendo World to get these two swords and these two pages of the coloring book.
Is there some way that somebody could get those from you, Frog?
I mean, they could also get this, too. That
wow.
1 out of 4,000. I mean, 4,000 copies made, still in shrink-wrapped, gold pages, leather-bound. If you donated $20 or more,
wow.
You can email me at progducto@gmail.com, progducto, with that proof of that donation, and I will be picking a winner for the end of the evening who will get not just one, not just Sklur and Ultima Scout, but Internet Explorer Smurfy.
I'm doing a really quick refresh. Are we ready for this? 7:59. Oh! Didn't expect to see a 9 there. $49,324. Let's throw that in the trusty Excel file. Paste special, paste text. Boom! We beat our goal by a K of dollars. What is C4? Why is this happening? No, our stretch goal is that one, 58K. And we are on our way, man. Yeah.
Is this Mango's link against Kage? It's looking really, really clean and fresh.
Oh! Yeah, it's beautiful,
yeah,
man. Holy crap,
that was
I
a
can't
good
believe
set.
It. All right, anybody who's just tuning in now, we wanted to... We've been talking about this for a while. Like, what do we want to do on this stream right now? Because we're just raising all this money trying to get Melee at Evo, and we wanted to take, like, a moment of pure, beautiful, like, in the most pristine form, Melee. What is competitive Melee about? So I'm going to take a really quick look at something. And I'm going to show you guys one of the pinnacles, one of the coolest, most fun moments that I personally have ever had at a tournament. I don't know about you guys. Maybe we should compile like all of our favorites, but yeah. That's what we're doing right now. So buckle your seatbelts, ladies and gents, because we are about to watch Dash His Wiz versus Mewtwo King.
Oh my
God.
Oh man, you guys might need to just put your shades on for this one.
At the revival of Melee.
I'll put the shades on for you guys. Oh my God, it's going to get really dark really fast.
So stream, I'm looking at the chat. Let me know if you can hear the audio.
I'm sweating. Alright, what stage are we taking?
Is he going back to stadium? Oh my God. Did Shiz random here? Is this a real thing? Is this real life?
I know not, apparently.
He did, man. This was back in the days when people just randomed it up. It was just game one was... Oh!
Yeah.
The Mewtwo King.
Yep.
I'm watching it in stream time. I don't know about y'all.
I'm as well.
I think Bobby should be too, just to get everybody on the same page.
Yeah, sure, I can do that.
Oh, man.
I remember I was standing...
That was not a good short hop down here.
Dude, that was what Sophie saw and was like, wow, this is my girlfriend, fiance. She saw it, she was like, wow, that's an amazing
Oh my god.
And then when Shiz started charging the upbeat, she was like, ha, like she thought he was disrespecting.
Yeah.
Oh god, I thought he was going to shine him there. Does everybody hear
that crouch cancel forward smash? Oh my gosh.
Damn. Oh! There goes your stock!
Settle down, we got this.
Dude, I love that line.
I was standing on a chair next to Can I Smash, my doubles partner, in court.
We gotta be almost ready. At the end of this stock, we gotta be ready for literally the best line that's ever been spoken in Melee commentary. And probably commentary history.
Well.
Stream, can you type to me what line I'm talking about? Please do it, and I'll donate, like, I don't know, I'll donate $5. What's the line?
Yo, the Shiz was real! Holy fuck! Holy fuck, what the shit? Wait, whoever the fuck said that set in Florida was the best match ever? Was sadly mistaken.
This isn't even grand final, son.
This is loser final.
What the fuck?
You were sadly mistaken.
Just a hat.
I don't want to hear no guns.
Damn.
Dude, can somebody call him?
I don't even want a commentary anymore.
You watch it? Can you call Az?
I'm going to scream into the mic like
Let me see if I still have his number. I just remember, Can I Smash Young out at the first combo?
And dude,
I'm done on main Falco.
Yeah, we got 84% to a fresh Falco stock.
Is it over? I don't know.
Olé! Olé!
Ooh.
Holy shit!
Oh,
holy fucking shit! Are you kidding me?
What a video.
Are you kidding me?
I'm going to lower the volume so we can still hear Mogwai screaming. Are you kidding me?
Are you kidding me?
He's doing like the William Shatner of commentary. Are you kidding me? He's just going crazy, man. Man, that was like the craziest set I've ever seen. We're going to try to get the big guy, Hazard, on the show, if at all possible.
Yeah, I don't have his number, so D1, it's up to you.
I have his number, of course, because we're best bros.
We got 1,000 people on our stream now.
Shout outs to the 1,000 people. Thank you guys for tuning in. This is Melee. We are watching some of the most fun fucking matches in the world. We're about to throw on... I would love to put that and a little bit of the chat.
You know, can we sync tube some of these matches so that we can all talk about them together?
What the F is sync tube? This is...
It's something so we can all watch the same one at the same time.
I don't know, man. I don't know how to do it.
All right. I will research that.
Please do.
All right. I'm on it.
Anybody who hasn't tuned in before, I'm Scar. One of your hosts. Joining me is Prague, Sheridan, and the man himself, Cactuar.
That is EMP Clash Tournament's Video Game Boot Camp Megabus 3 Glasses Prague. Science and technology.
Now, I haven't seen this match. But I know more or less. This is another Marth vs. Falco, because that's such an amazing matchup. And basically, so we're at 8 o'clock. We're thinking about this donation drive. We're raising a ton of cash money for Melee. Our mods are linking to the donation link every 5 minutes or so. Mods, please do that for us. If you support Super Smash Bros. Melee, help us charge this spirit bomb and throw it at the world and show the gaming world what Melee's all about.
But you know what, Scar? If we happen to get to EVO, we're going to have to figure out how to get there. And I think I know how. What if we took Megabus?
Oh, Megabus! Shout out to Megabus. Dude, also amazing news. Somebody had the idea to hashtag sadly mistaken. I think that's like, that should be like the new biggest thing.
You know what? I'm on that. Tweeting as we speak.
Hashtag sadly mistaken if you support... If you support Hazard coming on the show.
Whoever the fuck said that you couldn't reach Hazard?
So this happened at Apex, yeah? And this is on a corner TV, yeah?
It would appear so.
So this is like, you know, the caliber of matches that was going on at, you know, bracket of Apex was just insane. Wow. Oh, a bad turn of events. For poor Pew Pew. Let's see if we
get
can
it,
have
buddy.
Another M2K shiz moment.
This is not too bad quality for somebody to hang.
Yeah, this is like a video game camera.
Yo, that sad mistaken hashtag is popping off right now.
Popping off.
It's popping off.
Popping off.
Sick with it. Man, it doesn't look good for Kevin, but I just know he's going to bring it back.
How do you know? You know it in your heart.
I just know it in my heart.
You know it in your heart of hearts.
Kevin and I are one unit, along with the rest of Deep NorCal.
Sadly taken, too. That's pretty funny.
Oh, my God. Scar,
yeah.
This is a big one.
A big tweet?
Oh, God. No, Scar, what's your email?
BobbyScar@gmail.com. Now everybody in the world knows.
Scar, you're gonna get. Oh my God.
You tricked me, dude.
Like, whoever just emailed this to me just hurt my heart.
Oh my.
Is it like sadly mistaken at gmail.com?
just look, Scar. Just look.
That's extremely funny.
Scar, just look.
Wow.
That deep NorCal DI, man. You don't know. Oh. It's happening.
My heart.
It's happening.
This is a big one.
Where's my it's happening, Jeff?
Dude, holy crap. Did you guys all see that? Holy, can we just look at that last combo? It's brutal. That poor Falco. Also, can I just say, really quickly, first of all, LOL at Kevin looking like a deep-throated 13-year-old. Not everybody's going to get that, but it is true. And the other thing that I do want to say is, this is Bam. This is like the most attractive fucking person I've ever seen. Dude, I hate Bam sometimes. Look at that guy. Look at him. Dude, every time I talk to him, it's like, Jesus Christ. Who the fuck is this guy? Look at him. It looks like friggin' Zoolander popping up over here. In the corner.
West God, Balls that combo. You just gotta go for it.
Can we also just watch Husband one more time, please? Who does a down air grab? It's like he down aired and missed the L cancel, or hit the L cancel by accident, shielded, and like tried to jab or something. It's just so amazing that.
Just leave this link loaded on your computer at all times, just when you need that like little moment of inspiration, just to watch Husband.
So let's also take a
chillin', starts clapping.
That actually, fun fact, that was not footage from that moment.
That was from the FC crew battle, I believe.
Indeed it was. So, what am I doing here?
Some sick editing.
Am I playing this game is not over? Because that is true and not just play this and talk over this.
Dude, how about some of the,
Also, I got a fucking text message from guess who? I have it on my phone, but Hazard says that he has Skype on his phone, but does not have a Skype account. To which I'm going to caps locked LOOOOOL at him.
Girl, I'm sweating over here, man. I don't know if I can deal.
I asked him if he would make one for us.
Scar.
Yeah.
Did you see that?
I saw the email. I was super, super saddened by it. There's like a dream that did not come true. Does he mind if we share it on the stream? Oh, that was a dirty Falcon punch.
Ooh.
What did you see when you went ooh?
The Falcon punch.
Yeah, it's dirty. Dirty. This is a pretty... Dude, is Paul Pink Shinobi the Peach with the paw tag?
Probably, yeah.
This
Paul
is...
Vang.
Just saw a mango combo from the R word times two. It's also pretty sick music. I can't believe I have... Oh! It's a Samus combo coming up. It's insane.
And actually, the really cool thing about this video is that Ferris Wheel made it. And he recently was one of those guys that got the Pokemon community to help us out. So definitely a huge shout out to that guy.
Oh, wow. Who does that with Link? How do you tech your own bomb into an edgeguard?
Dude, Sheridan, have you not seen the Norwalk combo video?
Oh, I have.
Yeah, that's when my dude Joey did that crazy stuff. Oh, man. Uh-oh. Shh.
That's all right.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
The Wombo combo just happened on my stream.
Oh! Get your ass moved!
Subscribers, where's the Wombo combo? Thank you. Subscribers, Wombo combo. You got it.
Dude.
There we go. Bring it in.
Dude, you should see the Wombo combo reversed video.
Wombo combo reversed? No, I've never seen it.
It's hella good.
You want to get some laughs in?
Yeah.
Do you want to pause this? This is an 18-minute video. I was having fun, but not that much fun.
Okay, it's Wombo Combo spelled backwards is the title of the video.
Dude, I can't do that. Oh.
Obmok Obmo.
I remember when the Wombo Combo first came out, like, everyone was doing the parodies of it. Those parodies amazing.
I'm gonna go to the camera. You ready? Mm-hmm. Okay, by the way, Sophie's here. What's up with it? I'm gonna put Pac-Man on blast right now. Everybody knows Pac-Man on Karak.
Yes.
So, okay, I'm actually still salty about this. Hang on, I'm trying desperately to get this stream chat up.
Blast away.
Yeah, I'm about to put him on blast because there was a big tournament. PC Chris was at it. Cactuar, do you know which one I'm talking about? We all stayed at Sensei's house.
No.
Okay, so we were all staying at Sensei's house, and it was like literally everybody from TSA, including PC Chris, were like chilling out, having a good time, playing tons of Melee. And this is like when Wombo Combo was like the big thing. Everybody's talking about Wombo Combo. And of course, I'm like, dude, Blue Laser Combo is so much better. And I was just watching it, right? This is the time when I was not a Brandon and Phil, like, complete lover, which I am now. I've been turned. It's the truth. They are so amazing. Because they're just having such a genuinely good time when they're commentating. So anyway, I'm watching it, and, like, you know, if you really, truly listen to the Wombo Combo audio, there are people in the crowd who are screaming. As like like the building may as well have been on fire. Like there may have if there was a person in the in a room with like you know a giant machine gun, it would be the same screams that were you know evoked. It was like, and
yeah,
I was just
dude.
listening to it, and I was like, this is hysterical. Like, oh my, what the fuck? And I was just like, you know, I just listened to it like 800 times in a row, and I just kept laughing harder and harder. And, you know, I just had this idea. Let me watch this, like, to something else. Like, you know, somebody actually, like Garbage Day. If anybody knows Garbage Day, I'm actually about to show that. Because that's, like, an insane, this is actually where it started, right? And I'm sitting in the corner while PC Chris and a bunch of dudes are having a bunch of fun playing Melee. And I'm sitting there laughing with, like, you know, this little laptop. And, you know, here's Garbage Day coming up. This is probably the best video that's ever been made.
It's quite excellent.
And then that laugh at the end, right? It's perfect. So let's actually do the experiment really quickly. I'm gonna do it for you guys. This is what I'm doing. This is what I'm doing in Sensei's house by myself in the corner. So I've got Wombo Combo, and we got to get Brandon and Phil on. Oh my god, the first result is a picture of Patrick from SpongeBob. Okay. Well, whatever. All right, now stream. It's I want you to genuinely like think about what's happening in this room, and just like listen to the sounds that are being made. Now we're just excited, right? Okay. Now there's some screams happening right now, right? And let's just watch this one part that cracks me up, right? Let's just really seriously listen to these screams. So I think it's Mango, right? I can almost make out his voice where he just he's rising above every other sound. Oh my god! Just the god comes out so clearly. So let's run the experiment and see what happens when we watch Garbage Day with the audio of Wombo Combo. Let me try to match this up. So about 8 seconds. Seriously,
it sounds like a fatuous venture.
Watch me work my magic, Sheridan.
Okay, all right.
You've been a doubter before, and I've converted you. So this is a 21-second. All right, so we gotta get it to about here.
And now, Zoo.
Ready?
Poor
Zoo.
Wombo Combo.
That ain't Falco.
That ain't Falco. Oh!
Oh my god!
I was mostly skeptical that you'd be able to pull it off, but
you know,
it was good execution.
I'm like not kidding that I was practicing.
Dude, you gotta play Womblecom with spoof number 5.
My tech skill on that. Okay, so point being, back to the story. I invented this. I am the godfather of this idea of taking Wombo Combo and dubbing it to things, and it was stolen from me by Pac-Man. That's my story.
All right,
it's a roundabout way of telling it, but oh my god. Wombo Combo spoof 5?
Number 5 is the best one.
Is it the eagle?
Yeah, dude.
Oh.
That ain't Falco. All right, watch some more.
That
Wombo
one
Combo
and the
spoofs.
One with the Pokemon are the two best, in my opinion.
Up smash.
Happy feet. Wombo combo.
That ain't Falco.
Where are you at?
Oh my god. Wombo combo. Get your ass whooped.
Oh,
there's just
God.
So much excitement going on.
It's just
ridiculous.
So insane, dude. Man.
All right, I gotta bring us back down to earth for a second.
Don't do it to us, Prague. We're having too much fun.
So, for those of you that are watching the European Ensemble stream earlier, and also Fuzziness's Project Melee stream earlier, they were announcing the winners to some of the stuff they were giving away. So, Alfonso Salazar, if you are in here, you won the DK plushie. Vicky won the giant Charmander. Ryan Jacobs, you are walking away with the huge Poliwhirl plushie. This person, I can't pronounce their name. Voss Hogensen? I'm butchering your name. I apologize for it.
You don't know
You win both the Jigglypuff and Pikachu plushie. Chain Ace, Daniel Logan, getting the Raichu. Adam Martinson, of course. Volvagia from Sweden getting the Sonic plushie. Fraser Goldberg is winning the Sound Blaster headset. Gimpy Fish is winning the surprise Guile figure. Fraser, again, guess what? You're getting a Toad plushie. Nicholas Krauke is getting the Yoshi plushie. And everyone's favorite person, of course, Leffen, walking away with the Talking Togepi. And the entirety of this 25th anniversary Legend of Zelda stuff from that curse. Congratulations to all you guys.
Congratulations. Woo!
Sick with it. Look at all those prizes. I mean, you
got
to donate. You want, you know, I know somebody else that's got some prizes to give away.
You
remember
actually
who that
have,
was?
I actually have on me, like, where is it? I have my hospital wristbands from today. That's not it. I have my sunglasses, that's not it. I've got a Master Sword. Two Master Swords.
Two
Master
Swords?
Wait, do you have Crayola or Roseart? You know what, you don't like Crayola? Here's one for you. You like Roseart? I got one for you too. One for each.
Wow.
And you know what? We got that, again, that Legend of Zelda Hyrule Historia limited edition, 1 out of 4,000. 2 hours in the snow at Nintendo World. Already on eBay, $300. Leather bound, gold pages, still shrink wrapped. One person is walking away with all that tonight. So, again, email me if you are willing to roll those dice.
Well, that is fantastic.
So I'm going to do a little bit of shameless promoting. I hope nobody minds.
First, you should play Wombo Combo backwards.
All right, we're going to play Wombo Combo backwards. You guys ready for this or what? Are you guys ready for Obmok Obmow?
Let's see. Wow. Oh,
Samsung app. That's pretty good, man. All right, that's quite funny.
I've watched that almost as many times
as the real one. That is quite funny.
Hashtag
I'm gonna link
Samsung
it to you guys
app.
If you want to. Yeah, Samsung app. Really pass sound like milk. It. Yeah, let me do some shameless self-promoting right now. So if you guys are having fun, I know I am. I was like in tears with the Wombo Combo piece. If you're having fun, please head on over to twitch.tv/Bobby_Scar and do that thing where you follow me, where you do this about every week, and that's our general location. And please also follow this stream, VG Bootcamp. Thank you so much, VG Bootcamp, for letting us use your platform. You guys have worked so hard and have done a great job, you know, creating this sort of, what am I trying to say, this fan base that you've allowed us to use. So thank you guys so much. And yeah, if you guys want to follow us on Twitter, whatever. But now we're going to go back to awesome stuff. Why don't we check the donation drive?
Wait, before we do that, let's have that guy who was talking about that, because I think he found a microphone.
Oh, yeah, did they?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
No
here
way.
We go.
All right, we're about to get the man himself on. I'm not seeing it. I guess they just didn't message me.
What?
I just don't see it.
And also, while you're setting that up, a big shout to, of course, the man that has us all united in this effort to fight breast cancer. The main stage that we're all fighting for. Shout out to Mr. Wizard.
Shout out to Mr. Wizard. Shout out my friend. We're not like really friends, but you know.
Not yet.
Not yet.
He's likable guy.
It's only a matter of time.
I'm gonna show
free ice climbers.
Yeah,
free ice climbers.
I'm gonna show this one.
Oh no, that's not sorry.
Alright, so Inkblot Ponder as well, okay. So the entire emo staff is here.
Oh shit!
Wait, the Evo staff's here? Dude, how's it going, guys? We're just,
Dude, fix my hair.
Yeah.
I don't have hair.
Yeah, dude, we're not on stage, so, you know, let's just play with our hair and, you know, make sure that we're looking presentable. We're just showing what the Melee community is all about. We're showing some of my favorite, some of our favorite collectively moments. I remember that extremely well.
Oh, this turnip combo. Oh, my goodness.
My goodness.
And it is done.
I'll shave my head. We're fighting breast cancer. I'm already losing my hair as is.
Wow, that's a bold commitment, Prog.
I'll do it.
So I'm pulling Eric and Homie. Hello?
Hello?
Oh, listen to that sound quality.
Oh.
Who is that?
Hey, what's up, guys? Can you hear me?
Hey,
dude,
yeah,
Brandon, what is up, my friend?
What's up, Bobby? How you doing?
Pretty well, man. We're having a good time. How's the
yeah,
song
dude.
Go?
Oh, we're on camera now.
Sweet.
Save hey, with it.
Put it. I hate looking at myself. It's fucking weird. Yeah. But, yeah. How are you guys? Everything good? I see Prog with his glasses. That's tight.
So this is the President Brandon Obama.
Wait. So can I just ask the question of where that microphone came from?
Oh, so I went out and I basically hit up a record store and told me to go to a Radio Shack. So I hit up a Radio Shack and basically that's how I got it.
You listened to me when I told you to stand up, leave the comfort of your own home, and
I'm in a hotel room, dude. I'm in downtown San Francisco.
Eric,
of course, find the microphone.
Violence Lee.
Eric,
you,
domestic violence, Lee.
Domestic violence.
Which we don't condone, by the way.
Absolutely not. Eric, what are you
gotta
doing
be
here?
Be sharing his, like, avatar, that cat. Like,
it's my cat, man. It's my three-legged cat. He's
yeah.
the best.
Three-legged cat. There's somebody else in here, too, right? That does a show?
It's very man who demoralized you at Genesis 1 crew battles.
I got lucky.
Way to fuck my self-esteem.
That did suck, Brandon.
You got
Brandon
so many opportunities, though. To
the next
yourself.
One was close. The pound one was pretty close. I got aggressively, but that one was pretty bad.
Yeah.
For the longest time, I felt like I was running into this guy every tournament I went to.
Yeah, I was thinking that, too. I was like, fuck. Literally.
That is definitely up there with the career-ending sets. The career enders include you versus Catoir, me versus Toph at Northwest Manifest. Dude, that was the career ender for me.
Sure.
Toph still holds the record for breaking my heart most out of anyone in the world.
Nah,
I've
I think
had some bad losses,
it's you and watching you and Phil at your house late night.
Oh, my God. But that hypes me up. Okay, so this is actually pretty funny. We'll talk about it later. We got to get Phil on here at some point. But, dude, Phil and I, in the past, we've had nights where I've had him at my apartment. Like, Brandon, how late would we stay up? Like, literally, like 5 in the morning playing Melee, right?
Yeah.
And you would always fall asleep. But before you fell asleep, we were in, like, the heat of it, where Phil and I, he's like, you know, sometimes he just gets a good read on me, and he, like, starts playing Mario, and we start going even. He's like, man, you can't even beat my Mario. And I'm like, Phil, I'm actually like, I'm going to press start right now and murder your Mario. You suck. And we just
you
go down.
Get held mad and then go in the room and be like, you know what? I'm done, guys. Good night.
That's happened before.
Go to sleep.
We go down to this place where either I start winning and, like, you know, I'm a really bad winner, I think. I'm a worse winner than I am a loser. I think that I'm, like, really, really
good. That's an interesting way to put that.
When I start winning, you know, I start saying, man, you suck, dude. I whoop you every time. You know, I'll talk about it for like 3 or 4 months. You know, shout outs to who's that Falcon player? I beat him so bad, I don't even remember his name.
Roar. Yeah, you always got hyped about the victories that didn't really matter. Like, he beat like Macro Man 44 and be like hella hyped about it. He'd be like, he'll beat Lucian the same day, like, oh yeah, I beat Lucian. But like, my Master Falcon Man 44, though, it's crazy.
Yeah, I beat him so bad.
I never got that, but hey.
But yeah, there were actually, this is like true life story, times when Phil would beat me and I would feel so hopeless that I would be like, I'm going to bed. I'm done. It's like 11 o'clock. All right, I got to go to bed, man. I got to get up early.
What time are you getting up? 2 o'clock?
Just like too mad, dude.
50,000? I just looked at the number. It was at 47 last time I checked.
The Melee community is killing it. Dude, tell me a little bit about how you feel right now. How do you feel about the Melee community, you know? How do you feel listening to Wombo Combo, everybody knowing it? There's a custom graphic in this stream chat for Wombo Combo.
I didn't even know that.
Show Brandon the Wombo Combo thing. It's like super cool.
That's great. Like, man.
Look at that, man. You're like a legend now, right?
Oh, that thing? Tight. That's crazy.
Oh, shit. That's sick.
Wow.
So yeah, tell me what you think about the Melee community, you know, about Wombo Combo. Those are my two questions.
Well, as far as like Melee, with like, I guess we all got older, man, because there's no way that shit would have happened 5 years ago.
What?
Like raising $50,000?
Yeah.
No way.
Okay.
No way.
Yeah, you're right. Like, you're right.
That's just insane. Like,
you definitely.
Yeah, man. It's just, I guess that shows you how driven people are too. Like, mm-hmm. In terms of just seeing their game on the big platform, you know.
Mhm.
That's just like surreal, actually. Fucking $50,000, and we're not done. Like, that's amazing to me. You know, and it's cool as going to breast cancer. You know.
That's dope, man. And we are not done, are we?
I'm pretty. You know,
yeah, we haven't even dropped the bomb yet.
Yeah.
Haven't even dropped the spirit bomb. That's the truth right there.
Yeah.
See, Scar. We're
a long way as a community, put it that way.
Yeah,
my heart needs another Wombo Combo viewing right now.
You need to watch it one more time?
I need to watch it again.
The other one doesn't like that shit. Because it's like, I've had people come up to me like, yo, Wombo Combo, like, not Smash related. Like, I've been, like, walking and shit, and people,
dude, so like, we're out in the middle, 3 hours inland from the Bay Area, at a card shop, like, a 20-man tournament in Modesto, and people started getting hype over Doubles Losers Finals, and some dude playing Magic cards on the other side of the room goes, Wombo Combo! And Brandon just goes, motherfucker.
Yeah. Then he was like, oh, that's the guy? And he like fucking comes up and like bombards me like, yo. I'm like, dude, it's crazy. Like, it's cool to see, though, you know? Like, I never thought like that would have like as many views as it did at all.
Dude, what is it up to? It is currently at 2 million.
I think we
millions.
Should watch it. And, all right, yeah, right. Then we can find it.
This is what happens, Brandon. This is what happens when you run a stream. Everybody tells you what to do.
we were anticipating it before it happened. That's why we're like Happy Feet Wombo Combo, because they did it to Phil probably like 2 weeks before.
Yeah.
Yeah, but they didn't have a Shine Up Smash, so it was just like
and Mango obviously never saw it. All right, Brandon, can you hear the stream chat, or I mean the video I play?
No, right
well,
now.
You could probably relive it by heart, so I'm gonna play it right now. We're gonna...
Like, and I'm the one who edited that video too, so like I watched like 1,000 times before I even uploaded it.
Yeah, man. All right, so we're gonna listen to this this Wombo Combo, and we have the man himself on here, so. We'll talk about it after. This is like the most well-known moment in Smash for sure.
You just up Smash.
I was standing up when I was yelling too.
Happy Feet, Wombo Combo.
This is definitely the video. Definitely like a check point, you know. People they talk about like two Wombo Combo here, and they post Wombo Combo.
Nobody can hear you. Play the audio.
Yeah, that's how good.
Alright, so we have a few more viewers. I just want to play. All right,
that's
so
a crazy ass combo. I haven't seen that shit in a while.
It's really insane. So I'm not going to tell the whole story again, but I made the point. I was literally talking about this for like 5 minutes, you know, 20 minutes ago. But there's a moment in there where you hear like the screams are so real and like so horrifying. And I just want to play it one more time. So just listen and imagine that this is a Smash Brothers video game being played. You know, we're really passionate about the game, but just imagine that somebody ran in with a knife. Just imagine that that's what happens. See if you can imagine.
It's a crossover between me and Bobak yelling simultaneously.
No, Bobak
was playing. He didn't say a word that whole match until that shit happened. He could just sit there and then he could just yell.
Just horrifying. Voluminous. You know.
That's crazy.
Yeah, like if you played this to a person on the street who had no idea what this video was, and you played the audio to them, I mean, what do you think they think would be going on?
Dude,
this
is
like
actually
some kind
amazing
of massacre.
Wait,
yeah.
That's an amazing question. If you play the Wombo Combo audio to like your teacher.
Yeah. See, I'd probably do it, but since I'm the dude yelling, I probably wouldn't do it.
You think they would like, recognize your voice?
Yeah, I think so.
I think so too.
Yeah. Is that you, Brandon? That sounds just like you.
Dude, Brandon, so the question on everybody's mind is, when will we see the return of Brandon and Phil behind the mic?
Yes. Dude,
there's 1,200 people watching right now, so you better tell me what I want to hear. You better say tomorrow it's going to happen.
No, I don't know. I mean, I think a lot of it for me personally is like people walking up while we're commentating. Yeah, like I hate that shit personally. It's like say I'm commentating, I'm talking like right now, and then some dude just hovered over me as a, you know, like you.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm not bothering you guys if you're talking to me.
Yeah,
then,
dude. Like
and then,
also when like, I'm like TOing and stuff, people like looking over my shoulder into the bracket, like seeing what I'm doing. It's like. I just want to have my space, man. Just let me work. I'm sure that's how you're feeling about it, too.
Yeah, exactly. And then they chime in, and I'll be like, yeah. I'll say some rant. Yeah, it's Fox Sheik. Yeah, this match was Fox's favorite. Like, dude, what the I don't even know you. Like, I've had those, like, a few times. You know? Like, a lot of times, actually. It's like, I think they're so, like, awed by the fact that we're commentating that they, like, you know. That's not everybody. Yeah. You know, I don't want fucking, when I commentate, everybody be all scared, like, fucking, you know, go near him. But it's just, that's like a pet peeve. And then a lot of it, too, is just like, me and Phil are never at the same tournaments. Like, especially me, because I work a lot. So, for those of you, like, people always, like, wonder, I guess this is, damn, there's 1,200 people here. Okay, so, a lot of people wonder, like, where I've been at and shit, melee-wise. Well, I have two jobs now, so it's hard to balance that shit. Like, it's really hard to go to tournaments. And then when I do, it's like I'm there for a little bit, then I'll leave. I don't think I've stayed at a whole tournament for like, I don't know, a long time. Last big tournament I went to was Genesis 2. So, but like Evo would be dope if we had that opportunity. Because like, I see everybody else commentating, I think like, dude, we can do this shit. But I think it's just a matter of just like getting me and Phil in a room at the same time.
Speaking of Phil, dude, who was the girl he wanted to get a date with?
Natalie Kelly.
Is it yep. Nathalie?
Natalie.
Isn't that how you spell it?
Nah,
okay. Hang on.
Once you find out, you'll be like...
Let's bring this back. Okay, let's actually... We got to talk about it. We got to frame it. Brandon, you probably know all about my date with Natalie Kelly. Yeah?
Dude, I know everything.
So give us, like, the background. So it never happened for Phil, right? That's a spoiler alert. Phil never had a date with her. So now that we have all these people behind us, we got like, 1,000 people watching... First of all, we're going to show it to the crowd, and then, you know, we want to revive this. We want to tweet at Natalie Kelly. You know, we want to get her to know, put Phil on her radar.
Right? She responded to him, but she told him to ask his boyfriend, and I think Phil just never, like, I don't know. He just never – I don't know if he went through with that, you know?
Well, we're going to
– fucking awkward. Like, yo, I go out with your girlfriend, like – You know, like, what if I asked you to go on a date with someone? Like, would it be awkward as fuck? Like, yeah, hey, Bobby, can I go out on a date with your girl? Like, you know, like not saying he would say it like that, but it's just that,
yeah.
I don't know.
Well, she just
felt that way.
I don't think she was actually asking him to ask.
Imagine it.
Yeah.
I never could have created a more perfect moment.
But it's just, this is a classic
chat,
video.
Like, Bobby's chat, dude, is crazy. Right, I did not realize, like, people were this hype. Ridiculous. Okay,
so the video is actually playing right now. We're looking at Phil. Like,
dude, just hella funny. Team. He sits down.
You remember the show. Dude, this is like the best
Natalie
video.
Kelly, who I first saw in the film, yeah. Fast and Furious.
This is like all that VHS, like, has the date and shit. Like,
I feel like there's an attraction there. Can I be your friend? Natalie, from what I can see, you're a kind sweetheart.
I can't hear the audio, though.
I know.
So I ask, will you go out with me?
Yeah, I didn't realize how fine Phil's look that's
quiet,
I felt this was the best way to get in contact with you, get a chance to know you on a more personal level. We'll take some time, think it over. All right, now this is where you guys come in. So unfortunately for you, this video is going to need a ton of views. So please subscribe for more videos and updates. Tell your friends.
Alright, I'm
she
just
says
gonna
yes.
Play it in the background.
Record it, put it on YouTube for y'all to see.
But
she
I'm
says,
linking
no.
this.
That's unfortunate.
I love
that.
Mods,
last
you guys have to link
just
this
to keep
video,
things
like
things
every...
interesting.
Yo, this match was epic in 09. Damn.
That is the best.
He's crazy looking back.
If you just see, like, if you just watch, like, 3 or 4 times Phil pick up the thing of tea and just, like, sip it, it is just, like, so classic.
I mean, dude, I saw that part. Even back then, like, the tea part, like, had to be the most hilarious shit in the world. Oh my god!
Hey, what time it is?
Oh, dude, Hazard can't get on the show. Spoiler alert. Okay,
it's
so
it's almost 15 minutes.
Time to remind everybody of what time it is. So there's the five of us. You know, we're doing our best to sort of spread the word and bring us all together. Mods, please link to the WePay link, and there's also a PayPal link in the Twitch TV info section. So right now, it is, and I'm just told to play something, I'm going to pause it, and it's Rent for a Scar number one. I'm not going to play this right now. It's 8:43. So we made a promise to you guys that
snaps.
At 9 o'clock PST, right? That's like in 15 minutes is what I'm trying to get at.
Yeah.
We are going to muster everything that we have left as your matchers, which you guys have, you satisfied all the requirements, you showed up in, you know, in droves, and you donated above and beyond what we asked. So we're going to take all of our energy and throw it together into this pot. 9 o'clock is the time. So, you know, other games are catching up to us. We're actually going to take a quick look at what the standings are. Skullgirls took a big jump from 32 to 36. Super Turbo is still at 39. I think they maybe lost some momentum due to the recent
announcements. I think they're doing like a PayPal thing, and then that PayPal account's going to donate to the thing in their own massive bomb.
That makes sense. And Super Smash Bros. Melee is currently at $51,207. Good
wow.
shit, guys. let's use these final few minutes before the Spirit Bomb to, you know, gather some cash, and yeah. get ready to throw it in with us. So this is us all lifting our hands up. And if everybody in here, if you have five additional dollars, I know that we've been asking for so much money from you guys, and, you know, thank you so much. If you can just do it with us, and we can all do it together, show what we're capable of.
Yeah, guys.
That's coming up. It's 8:44. We're throwing it in at 8:59 or whatever. So that's the announcement. Anybody else want to add to that?
I will go ahead and announce, you know, again, this is about that eighth game making it to Evo, but again, we're all uniting, all the communities uniting, again, to fight breast cancer, which is a very, very venerable cause. Don't forget that's the main goal behind all of this. However, it's been, we have 12 years of history. Melee was at Evo 2007, Brawl 2008, and Scar, you mentioned some of your guests that were going to be here tonight.
I
actually would like to hear from the last Evo Melee winner, this defending champion himself.
Let's see if he's here and waiting to get on. And while we get him on, oh yeah, he's calling me. That's pretty funny to make Ken wait, though, I'll tell you the truth. So, yeah. While I'm waiting to get you on, I'm going to play this wonderful video as we charge up the Spirit Bomb. By the way, I'm kind of like doing a voiceover over the music to Don't Stop Believing, so... This is about as inspirational as a speech can get. We're looking at probably Goku taking an educated guess here. Just look at his hands. Look at the
energy. Hey, was it? Yo, my bad, but dude, the Spirit Bomb took like 4 episodes, man. I swear.
We've been charging it for like 3 days.
I was pissed.
Don't worry about it. So you see the
And then Frieza just like sat there and laughed after he hit him with it.
God damn it, Brandon. Look at this scary dude. We're not gonna take no.
This is a different Spirit Bomb though. We got a Smash Spirit Bomb. Exactly. So we're good.
Look at all of this power. This is what we can do when we put our power together. When we add our strength to each other's to form the super Spirit Bomb.
Yeah.
No, this is the wrong clip.
Yeah, I don't think he... Yeah. Where's the Spirit Bomb
Dude,
at?
it's coming. You see, it's charging Jesus.
Yeah, I know. I'm telling
you,
this guy.
Takes
hell
He's about
episode.
To get junked by the Spirit Bomb. Hold on to that feeling.
Wow. Oh, tried, Bobby.
It was pretty good. Yeah. Pretty good.
Please don't do that again.
All right. Should we keep Brandon on while we get Ken on?
That would be dope.
All right, guys, we're about to add the much revered, polarizing, almost champion of Survivor, Ken Sephiroth, Ken Huang, to the chat. Boom! That looks like either Sephiroth or Ken. Can't even tell. Or Marth.
Spirit Bomb's the way to go, guys.
Spirit Bomb.
You guys got this. Believe. We can do it. Oh, we already did, kind of. Kind of. My hype is terrible. I'm trying. I'm real trying.
Can you hear, dude?
Hey, guys, can you hear me?
Oh, my God. It's the voice that we all know and love. Ken,
hey, what's up, Ken? I've never had a conversation with Ken, so I just wanted to say hi real quick. How you doing, Ken?
Hey, is that homemade waffles?
This is homemade waffles, yes.
He knows you by voice. Sick.
He actually got me back into Smash for Kings of Cali because I heard his Wombo combo.
Wait, you heard Wombo combo for the first time 6 months ago?
Yeah, yeah. Wow. I was just like... going through YouTube, and then I saw like a little featured Smash, like a featured video of Smash. So I clicked on it, and it was a Wombo combo. So I clicked on it. It was so much hype. So just wanted to get me like to commentate afterwards.
Yo, that's dope. Yo,
proving to us officially
that people have been telling me about that. That's pretty crazy. Like, never would have thought, like, you know, Ken of all people, you know.
Yeah, and I think that you definitely proved to us, like, definitively that you were living under the proverbial Smash rock for, like, 3 or 4 years, right? You didn't know it. You didn't know anything about what we were doing. Is that right, Ken?
Yeah, I haven't after Smash, after Raw, I pretty much quit. I was out of the scene for a long time.
Yeah.
I wasn't like keeping up with it or anything. I just moved on with life, pretty much.
Dude, so we're opening up everything in the world to asking Ken a question. You know how rare it is to talk to Ken. So ask Ken questions in the chat. And if you want to tweet at me, I'm going to prioritize Twitter questions.
Oh, actually, I would like to. I want to say something.
Yeah, I was about
actually,
to ask.
Like,
go ahead.
I put the Melee link out, and I think we were on the radio and stuff in Australia and stuff, and people started donating to our cause too. So
that's insane.
Oh, wow.
So people all over the world are helping support breast cancer and Melee, anyways, into Evo.
Fantastic. That's great news.
So yeah, our numbers have jumped up a lot recently. So I was pretty proud of the community. We've gone a long way since I started, anyways.
Yeah. So what are you doing nowadays, by the way?
I am actually running my own food truck business in San Diego. I opened it up with me and my siblings. And yeah, awesome. That's pretty much it.
So
and
I just saw probably the best question that'll ever be asked. Will you name one of the sandwiches and or sandwich plus drink the Ken combo?
We actually been thinking about that.
So we need to stop thinking about it and turn this into a reality. What will the Ken combo be? Go.
Probably a sandwich, probably a steak sandwich with two egg rolls and a Vietnamese iced coffee.
Boom!
I would buy that immediately.
The Ken combo. How much are we going to price
that
at?
Hella good.
Can we make that like a bit more expensive than everything else or a bit cheaper? Right? We could do either angle.
Probably cheaper. A combo is always going to be cheaper than a full price thing, right?
And so why don't we bump your business? Where can I go? Like, say I drive down to SoCal tomorrow. If I wanted to eat a Ken combo, I've experienced them many times, right? But if I wanted to eat one, where would I go?
We have certain locations, but you just check out all our locations on our website, hongiesfoodtruck.com, and you can find exactly where we are. All
right.
I actually had a couple of Smashers stop by and had some sandwiches with us, and I got to talk with them, which is pretty cool.
That is really
pretty
cool.
Funny, yeah. They were like, oh, we're Smashers. I was like, oh, whoa.
So can I ask you a serious question?
Shoot for it. Go for it.
Now that you know that it would have been possible for a Ken combo to be on the menu, do you feel like you deprived them out of, like, you know, a really great story by not, you know, having that when they came to eat?
Yeah, of course. They didn't.
Do you know what I mean? It's, like, really sad for me because if I had gone to the Ken establishment and didn't have a Ken combo but knew that if I had gone, like, 2 months later I could have, this is, like, you know, heartbreaking. I might lie about the story and say I went and I had a Ken combo at Ken's truck.
Ken combo and a Wombo combo to go. That'd be kind of crazy.
Yeah,
wouldn't
oh,
it?
Dude, what
Wombo
if we had. Dude,
the, well, but
somebody in the
stealing,
chat posted
though.
A great idea. What if we had Ken's food truck at Genesis 3?
Ken, will you come to Genesis 3, dude?
That sounds great.
I don't know about that. That's a far away.
Oh,
we haven't taken our truck out.
No,
of
I'm just. Yeah, it was just for fun. But
dude,
yeah,
how much?
That would be amazing.
Whatever would make it worth it, you gotta let us know what would make it worth it for you to come up, and we'll do our best to get you like the most exposure in the world. How about that? Genesis 3, sponsored by Hoang. What is it called?
It's called Hog.
Throwing combo Hoang sandwiches. Bam.
Amazing.
Isn't Wombo Combo the pizza from Round Tables?
Yes.
Yeah, that's like Isaiah's favorite pizza. Every single time I went to a NorCal tournament, he would always talk about a Wombo combo.
So we have,
I think that's why they named it, because
it's funny though, because I looked for a Wombo combo at Round Tables, and they only served King Arthur Supremes down in SoCal, but in NorCal they call them a Wombo combo.
Hey, you know what would be crazy? To talk with the CEO of Roundtable. I'll bet he's seen that video. I bet you've seen it.
I bet you he has, dude.
Put money on
it. Didn't, like, take advantage of it, you know?
Yeah.
Like, put like, an ad where you have, like, the Wombo combo audio in the background, but it's, like, something completely different. Like, all the other YouTube videos.
Yeah.
Only you're actually trying to sell a Wombo combo.
I don't know.
I can't
if
believe
they
you didn't take advantage of it.
I don't know if they can have Bobak stick his heart in their commercial.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking. Like, if you cut out the profanity and have this as, like, a legitimate commercial, it's like, you know, Wombo combo! Get your whooped!
It's
just like, you gotta do a lot of work to sort of get it ready for being on the big screen.
Yeah, that's true.
So I have some amazing questions for you, Ken, on Twitter. You ready for them?
Yes, I am.
The first biggest, the most amazing question I've ever heard is, who is your favorite Smasher?
My favorite Smasher...
Asked by Jolteon Beast. Thank you for that question.
That is a hard one.
Right?
My favorite Smasher, who inspired me? I don't know. who do I like? I like to watch... I used to like to watch Boggle Players, Bomb Soldier back in the day. ShizWiz definitely inspired... Or I liked watching ShizWiz play. Azin, PC Chris. Basically, like, all the pros back in the day.
Yeah. Dude, I'm going to ask my own question. Can you tell me about your relationship with Isaiah? Your team's relationship, how you guys got along.
You want to know the story of me and Isaiah since the beginning? Like, how I first
met him? How long will it take you to tell it?
Too long. Do you want me to just sum it up?
Tell me the 4-minute version. We're going to charge the Spirit Bomb as Ken tells us the story of the most beautiful team's union in the history of the game. Put our hands up and give Ken the stage.
All right. Went online. Then he wanted to play Smash 64, and then I challenged him to a 64 money match because I thought I was like the best at 64. And
wait, 1 second. Can we clarify? You thought he was the best at 64?
No, I thought I was the best at 64 at the time. So it was going to happen at TG4, my first national tournament. So I went there, and then I saw him like demolish everybody at 64, so I pretty much backed down. I was like, oh no, there's no way I can beat this guy. So then I just played him for fun and he just worked me. And then afterwards, I talked to him online some more and I said, you're really good at 64. I think that your 64 skills is going to translate to your melee skills. We should, you know, you should come down to my house for a week. We should train, get better, play Smash. And he was on board. He did it. He came down. We played Smash. We practiced basically everything. I think there was a time where we stayed up all night and we were practicing power shielding. We'd get like the two laser guns with items, and then he'd shoot me like 10 times, and I'd get like 2 out of 10. Then I'd shoot him 10 times, he'd get like 8 out of 10. And then afterwards, he's like, "Oh, this is stupid. No one's really gonna do this anyways." So we just like stopped doing that. But yeah, pretty much we just played. We got along really well, and then we became partners after that. Ever since. And that is the story. That is the beautiful story of Ken and Isaiah. And we got our team name by going to eat at Rubio's one time, and they had a dessert called El Chocolate Diablo. And we just had dessert, and then we just said, hey, why don't we just name our team after that?
Wow.
And we became the El Chocolate Diablo.
That is really an inspiring story. Thank you for sharing that with us, Ken.
So everybody knows now.
Everybody knows now. And did you guys always get along or what? Can you tell me about the biggest fight that Ken and Isaiah ever had?
The biggest fight? Oh, that's probably in Japan, when we were in Japan. And
you were just
Isaiah,
like, fuck you, Isaiah.
Yeah, Isaiah wanted to do his own thing. He was like, just wanted to do his own thing. And I kind of wanted to keep our group together as a group, like unity. And he just wanted to go off on his own. I said, no, you gotta stay with us. And he was like, no, I'm going off my own.
Listen to Ken, guys. Unity. Donate now. We need more power.
And he just went off on his own. And then when he got back, we were just like pissed off each other the whole entire trip. It's pretty bad.
That's all Isaiah's fault, dude. I heard the story and I made my judgment. All right. I'm going to have to play some beautiful DBZ music.
All right, it's getting
best,
time.
What's the
you want to hang out for this, Ken?
Of course
we have
I do.
About
of course
55
I do.
5 seconds left until we drop the bomb. It's going to be like December 31st. Get that countdown ready.
I can't wait to see this happen.
Hands in the air right now. Everybody, get your hands in the air.
Put your hands in the air, guys.
You too.
Get
watching.
Ready.
Everybody's putting their hands in the air.
Donate.
I see.
You can't see it, but I have my hands in the
air. $20, whatever you can donate. Now is the time.
Goku, we need it.
We need more power.
Goku.
Yeah, I actually have to donate to you. I need to focus right now.
Only my hair can turn yellow right now.
My hair's already
yellow. We are all turning our hair yellow.
Well, it's being black. Does your hair turn? I remember Shiz said his hair would turn purple and his eyes.
That's what my guess was, like purple.
All right, it's time.
10 seconds.
Scar, can you do the honors?
I have to. Can somebody
should
tell
play
me
that song? You dropped the bomb on me.
It is now 9 o'clock.
What we're doing? Countdown.
What did we start at?
$43,504. That was what we started at.
And after the Spirit Bomb, I'm dropping a massive amount of money thanks to all of your PayPal donations. Boom! Dropped.
Oh my gosh.
Let's see.
The Spirit Bomb. Oh my God! It's just enveloping everything.
Are you looking at it? Does anybody know what it is? Oh my God!
Oh shit!
Damn!
That's just the start of it too.
Where's the scene? What one do I have to go to?
Crazy Spirit Bomb, guys.
Wait, how do I show it? Damn it! I'm so bad with this program.
You gotta practice. I told you to practice in your room,
dude.
Man.
It's the Dragon Ball Z effect. You can never do anything in one episode.
I told you, man. It's at least four. It's at least.
Let's see if.
Boom! Oh.
56 G's, my friends.
Woo! What? Wait, what?
Dude, I dropped 2K.
I man. See 52.
I see 52.
Refresh,
also.
Motherfuckers.
No, I did refresh.
It's 56.
I don't see anything.
The number on my screen is $56,721.36. Who's
those
on
are called cents.
Abraham Lincoln's.
Those are called cents.
What is happening to Majin Buu right now? Kid Buu, I just got my power back thanks to the Dragon Balls. Good luck to everybody else. We have thrown in our ultimate power. This is the idea that we couldn't do it, getting evaporated.
Man, that's a $6,000 spirit bomb. That is the most expensive spirit bomb I've seen.
Right, I don't know what to say, but, you know, we're not even done yet.
That's only one spirit bomb?
That's only part one. Man, dude, I was talking to my boy Salsa in the show, we have not seen this final clip.
Have you guys dropped a foot down Gohan yet? You think that one? You haven't dropped that one yet?
No, that was...
Is that the last one?
Congratulations, my friends. My family. We've got it.
Damn. Yeah, it still says 52 on...
No,
you
have
to press but it's,
it takes a while to...
1,400 viewers, man. Thank you guys for watching. That
thank you
crazy.
Guys. Thank you guys so much. Press Control and then press F5.
Why? Yeah. What is
control
that?
First,
what's the difference?
Control clears the cache, and it's like, you know.
Yeah.
That's crazy, man. I didn't realize like so many people tune into the show.
We just blew it. We blew everything up, man.
Peace.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Oh, thank you guys so much. Let me just ask for a tiny bit more support. Please follow this Twitch channel, twitch.tv/, I don't know what it is, VG Bootcamp. And if you guys don't mind, I would really appreciate, if you're enjoying Melee It On Me, we do this every week and we have a ton of fun every single time. Please navigate on over to twitch.tv/Bobby_Scar. That's me. And press that follow button. And it's going to be awesome.
All right.
We're
going to
do it
you
every week. So this is actually the official end of Melee It On Me Episode 6, and we're about
wait,
to do
Scar,
an extended after party.
I gotta
I'm
going to
let
Prog
talk.
I gotta do something first.
I'm gonna let him talk.
I mean, all the entries are in. It's past midnight my time. Normally I have to sleep because I work in the morning, but since I had surgery, I'm off tomorrow. So I'm gonna do it now anyway. I have 378 entries.
Oh my God.
So I have everyone in an Excel spreadsheet. I'm going to generate one random number. And the winner is going to walk away with his and hers, or his and his, hers and hers. I'm open to it all. Master
Theirs
Zords.
And theirs.
Exactly. And then when you adopt, you have your own children, you get puppies, kittens, whatever. They can color rose art.
Where's Brawler?
It's whatever you want to do, guys. And of course, that before bed reading, limited edition Hyrule Historia, 1 out of 4,000, already on eBay, $300 a pop, only available at Nintendo World in New York City. I waited 2 hours in the snow, and someone's going to get it with just a couple of minutes or a couple of days, thanks to the United States Postal Service or UPS, depending if it's international. But between 1 and 378, the lucky number is 264, which means tonight's winner. Oh my God, are you kidding me?
You.
No.
You win? Is it Levin?
No. Nope.
God, I can't take this.
So, there have been a lot of people who have done a lot in helping us raise all this money to fight breast cancer and to make it to that main stage at EVO. But in the last couple of days, one person has stepped up above and beyond, and he was numbers 262 to 271.
Wow.
A big
congratulations, S-Bat! Woo!
Oh, sick. Zach got it?
No. It is...
Zach looks like he'd win a random
Zimmerman comment. From what? Cinnamon Sin.
Zimmerman Sin oh. from Cinnamon Sin!
Mewtwo King somehow wins. I don't get it.
Congratulations, Mewtwo King. You are truly an inspiration to us all.
If you want proof, I'm uploading it to my Twitter right now.
Congratulations.
You just drive it over to him.
Sometimes Mewtwo King's down, but he's never out, especially not in our hearts.
I'm so mad he won.
No, he's the best. Congrats, M2K. So,
congrats.
We're going to officially end episode 6 of Melee It On Me. Gamer, I would appreciate it. Oh!
Hey, you guys.
I would appreciate it if you changed it to the after show. Before I do that, I'd love to sign off from everybody. Yeah?
Are you kidding me?
Go around the horn. Sheridan, why don't you kick us off?
Well, I'm just... I can't even begin to tell you just how impressed I am with everybody. I mean, we thought that the first drive we had was absolutely insane, mm-hmm. and that was all we were going to need at the beginning of this drive, because we got $9,000 in.
What, 9,000?
With our matching. I know, and I mean, we've more than doubled that drive in the last 3 hours, and we're not even done yet.
Sheridan.
So this is just, I'm just blown away.
Can I tell you something?
So thanks to everybody.
Can I say something from the bottom of my heart?
Do it.
Whoever the fuck said that first drive back on the 15th was the best drive ever, you were sadly mistaken. Boom! Hazard prevails.
Thanks, Sheridan. Sorry.
Did I miss that guy? Shout out to Haz, man.
I think we're lagging a little bit. In the Skype chat.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Don't worry about it. It's not a problem. Cactus, are you going to stay with us in the after show, or are you going to dip out?
I'm going to stay for a little while, honestly. Yeah, I feel like I didn't talk much, and I don't know if people want to ask questions or get more involvement out of me for today. But I do want to say that I'm... What's that?
I said, we'll stick around and bullshit for a while.
Yeah. I do want to say that I'm, like, really proud of the Smash community. I know when Brawl came out initially, we weren't even sure if we were going to survive, but 5 years later, here we are, stronger than ever, raising over $50,000 for breast cancer. It's huge. It's a huge sign from our community. We are not on the decline. We want to keep this game strong. We love it. And thanks for all the support, guys, honestly.
Good shit, Cactus. Totally agree. Ken, you want to say goodbye? You don't have to leave, but...
okay, I'm going to put some emphasis into this, and the stream chat can just finish it off. I don't know, man. I don't know, man. I don't know. Come on. No one's saying it. What? There we go. I don't know, man. It can go either way.
Dude, how do you feel about the it can go either way? Are you like the proudest that you could ever be that you said it? Is this the best summary of anything ever?
I just had a lot of fun with commentating, and then I don't know, people started avoiding me, so it's all good fun.
Your phrase.
Well, you know, it was a very honest assessment of
a ditto matchup.
Yeah.
I mean, hey, man, you know, it could go either way.
Absolutely.
I'll stay for the after party or the after discussions and stuff and hang around for a bit.
Fantastic.
And people can ask more questions and stuff. But yeah, I'll stay for a bit.
Awesome. Brandon, I'm going to go to Prog last because he's just
homies. Nah, just shout outs to all you guys, man, for donating that much money. Like, for breast cancer, for evil, all that stuff. The fact that, like, we can all get together and do something like that is just, like, you know, surreal.
Just
so
giving them all day.
Shout out to you guys. Give yourselves pats on the back for those who donated.
Thanks, Brandon. Yeah. Ah, that felt nice.
Bobby, too. I know you put a lot into, like, advertising. Prog, Sherry, and everybody. Cactar. There you go. I saw you back yourself.
How about you, Eric?
Yo, like,
dude, thank you so much for your continuous contributions. Dude, Eric donated hell of fucking money to this.
I mean, yeah, Eric's...
Thanks, man. Well, when we started, I just remember how this started. It was Prog. He had the idea of donation matching, and I was like, oh yeah, I can definitely get behind that. And then Bobby was just like, yeah, you know, I'm gonna like donate twice as much as both of you combined. Just saying. And we were just, and that just started like this huge snowball hype train that I've never seen before in this community. Like, every single expectation that I could possibly come up with for this community was completely shattered. Like, I could not even begin to comprehend that we would be where we are today. I have no words other than that. Like, seriously, it's ridiculous. Beyond ridiculous.
And you, Prog?
I just really want to say this whole donation drive has brought out both the best and the worst of a lot of different communities that are being represented. And it's always stellar to end on an extremely high note. So guys, act with class, act with tact. This isn't over by any stretch of the imagination. I know more donations are rolling in. I know, of course, me being from New York, we got a Steve Novak who's waiting in the wings with a three-pointer open. But, you know, no matter what happens, we aren't done. There's a lot of work that has to be done. And it's not going to be done without this type of effort continuously. We saw how we all united so quickly. And we need a lot of that in order to be like Super Turbo, a game that's been around for 20 plus years, to have that same love behind it as Skullgirls, which we already know they have. So it's fantastic to see what you guys have done. I hope to see a lot more of it. And a big shout to each and every one of you, whether you donated, whether you spread the word, whether you're tuning in, if you're picking the controller for the first time, you're watching it, see my voice is cracking, I'm about to cry.
I made you hella big on the thing too, so now everybody can see a big blown up picture. We can see exactly where the earphones are going into your ear cavities, dude. So much love to you, Prog. Put those shades on. Put the other one on.
But again, like I always said, this really hit home for me. There's a lot of times I've been disenchanted with this community. I have no problem saying that. But especially everyone uniting for one really superb goal. And especially, like I said, I got Super Turbo December 24th, 1992. My grandmother passed away of breast cancer December 26th, 1992. 2-day difference. This is gamers of all kinds uniting to do something great, and we're never going to hear about it, but each of you know that you are part of it, so you can never, ever let yourselves... You know what you did, be proud. One unit. Scientology.
Thanks, Prog.
Thank you, Prog.
And hey, man, everybody said everything that I could say much better than I could say it myself. I'm so proud. I love you guys. Seriously, I said it over and over, but my friends and family are right in this chat, right in this stream. Much love. One unit. Let's keep that going. We can, like, when we act as one, when we throw our hands up in unison, shit we can do is crazy. So anyway, we're going down. Thank you guys so much. Thanks for tuning in. We'll be back next week. We do Wednesday shows. And so what we're going to do right now is we're going to go down. We're going to come back up. I'm going to get a beer, and we're going to hang out. I think the theme of the after party should be the one unit idea. I want you guys, if you can, to call in and tell us the coolest Smash experience you've had. Tell me about the homies. Tell me about the best tournament. So on and so forth. Peace, guys. Wait.
Take it easy.
Oh, God damn it. I have to play the video. Oh, this is so
difficult. Are you able to play the video? Stay tuned to find out.
On the next episode of... Dude, they actually... That's a real thing. Did you know that?
What's up, Salsa?
On the next episode of Melee It On Me. The DBZ guy says it. I actually have it. Wait, where is it? I think that I put it in the Dropbox. Anyway, peace, guys.
Wrong video, Scar.
I'm trying. It's too powerful. I don't know if that's a real quote, but... Hang on.
It's sounding like
it's working!